The following is a production of Hometown and Home Country Radio Sports.
We've never seen a team like this before, ladies and gentlemen. After all this time, Bishop Garrigan is still golden. Bishop Garrigan has finally slain the Newell Fonda Dragon. Your Golden Bears are state champions for the second year in a row.
This place is packed, and it is going to be rocking in here tonight. Crooks tapped it backwards, and we are underway. Buckle your seatbelts, everyone. In the lane, Crooks, set up the paint. Oh, a nice spin move, and she lays it in.
Oh, with her left hand, she claps her hands and says, let's go. You got to feed Audie this last 2 minutes.
Three-pointer is blocked at the buzzer, and that's it. After coming so close the past 2 years, Bishop Garrigan has finally won it all.
Video streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube channel is brought to you by Kemna Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. Algona Municipal Utilities, community-owned for community benefit. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident. PMC Advantage Insurance, having the advantage makes all the difference. Now, here's Sports Director Tyler Lance.
It is the grand finale of the regular season as tonight, Bishop Garrigan bears down on its fifth straight conference title. The 19-2, number six ranked in Class 1A, Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears are visiting the North Iowa Bison, coming in at 7-13 overall, 4-11 in the top of Iowa West. With a win tonight, Bishop Garrigan will clinch their fifth straight conference title, but this one looks just a little bit different after the graduation of Audie Crooks and Molly Joyce. Some teams said that Bishop Garrigan would take a step back. This would be a down year that wouldn't repeat his conference title winner as well. If tonight, they could do it. They could get an outright conference title if they win tonight against the North Iowa Bison, a team they defeated earlier this season back in Algona, Iowa. I'm Tyler Lance here at Hometown Radio. We make that Home Country Radio KLGZ for tonight's broadcast here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. The regular season winds down as both teams know their postseason assignments and are set to get that underway later this week in North Iowa's case or next week in Bishop Garrigan's case. But one final regular season tune-up for both teams. You want to be playing at that 100% level, getting all those all the rust out right before the postseason, getting everything ironed out on both sides. So that makes this an interesting matchup tonight, that final tune-up here before both teams head into the postseason for North Iowa on Thursday and for Bishop Garrigan next week. We will talk with both head coaches heading into tonight's matchup, Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab, as well as North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer. They're coming up here on Home Country Radio KLGZ and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Girls high school basketball action right now on Home Country Radio as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears visit the North Iowa Bison. And right now we're joined by North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time today on the pregame show. Let's begin with a recap of this past Friday for your girls as you defeated Eagle Grove 50-39. So what are a couple of your big takeaways coming out of Friday night's game?
I think one of the biggest one is defensively, we were able to switch a few things up and not lose a whole lot from the defensive end, and actually we were able to create a few extra turnovers in the second half by switching up our defense, and that gave us a couple of easy layups, transition baskets out of that. And the other thing is we had some great shooting from a couple of our kids, so that helped us out tremendously from the outside because it was a bit of a challenge to get stuff on the inside against Eagle Grove.
And, Coach, at this point, you kind of have a core group of players right now that have been playing together for quite some time. Can you speak on the way they've sort of meshed as a unit over time?
Yeah, we've got two seniors and then two juniors that have been playing together here now for the last 3 years with those four together. And then, starting to mix in a few of our freshmen we have this year and just trying to find a combination that's been working well. We did some changes about midway through the season with a little bit of our starting lineup. And, the group we've got going on right now seems to be working well, as far as playing together, they're kind of feeding off each other. They're doing a good job of looking for each other in the offensive sets. If they get covered, they're looking to pass the ball out, looking for that assist and the open shooter. So, they're starting to see each other and starting to play well, and that's a tribute to them and their willingness to keep working at it and just keep improving as the season goes and with each game we have.
And, Coach, as you guys wind down the regular season tonight, you welcome the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears to your gym, obviously a team that you saw back in December. What were a couple of things that jumped out to you about Bishop Garrigan?
The biggest thing is their speed. They got quick guards. It's hard to keep them in front of you, but you've got to try to do the best you can. And, of course, their shooting. You leave them open any place on the floor, particularly from behind the three-point arc, and they're going to shoot the ball. And they've got a couple kids that can make those three-point shots. So, from their standpoint, they're a very well-rounded team. They've got an inside game again this year. But predominantly it's their guard play and the outside play that seems to really kind of take the center stage on that. And it's just, how are we going to limit those or control that from our defensive standpoint and, make it a little tougher on them offensively and have them, work for their shots and, maybe contest a few more and, see what happens defensively and, make it a little challenging for them.
Talking right now with North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer. Coach, what do you see as the biggest deciding factor for tonight's game?
I probably would say it's going to be the guard play and how well the ball is handled. Turnovers is going to be a key thing. If we can limit our turnovers, keep our turnovers down, that's going to help us from a defensive standpoint that we're not going to give up fast break points, transition points, and we're not going to give Garrigan the extra opportunities to get some of those possessions where we do turn the ball over. And the games that we've kept our turnovers down, we're in the mix throughout the game, and it's a little more in terms of competitiveness going on. But if we end up turning the ball over quite a bit, we can get out of hand quickly. So we're going to have to keep turnovers down, and we're going to have to make shots. If we've got open shots, we've got to step up and make shots and put pressure on them to continue playing good, solid defense on us.
Well, Coach, as we wind down the interview, along those same lines, obviously the playoff is going to start Thursday night for you guys, and this will wind down the regular season. But as a coach, what do you need to see tonight to really say this team is ready to go for the playoffs?
I would say a good solid defense, whether it be zone defense, man defense, and then, of course, offensively, we've got to be able to move the ball and find our open shooters. If we can do those things, keep our turnovers to a minimum, those are some of the keys that we need going forward here when the tournament start on Thursday, and those would be big things in terms of our success here in the tournament trail.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
All right, thank you very much.
That is North Iowa head coach Rick Meyer here on Home Country Radio. Right now, we'll step aside for a timeout. Bring you more next on KLGZ 98.5 FM and AM 1600.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmers State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona, trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
High school basketball action on Home Country Radio KLGC as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears visit the North Iowa Bison. And right now we're joined by Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab. Coach, obviously the team defeated West Hancock on Friday night 57-38. Then you don't have a ton of time in between then and when this game is, just a couple days of the weekend. So I guess what did the past couple days look like for you guys as you get ready for this final regular season game?
Well, we drew Saturday off and then came back Sunday afternoon. And had a good hour and a half practice, did some team stuff, and had a nice hour and 15 minutes of practice yesterday to work on some things and work on scouting reports and stuff for tonight's game.
And, Coach, as we said, it's the final regular season game, and as we talked about before, if you guys win tonight, it means an outright conference title for the girls. Can you talk about what that accomplishment would mean if the team was able to get it, especially just in the context of it being a new team this year, a new group that's had its own chance to establish its own sort of identity?
Yeah, if we're able to win that conference title outright tonight, I mean, that's a huge accomplishment for a very young team. You know, you look at our lineup 9-12, and we've got a lot of freshmen, sophomores, and juniors playing a lot of big minutes for us. Not that our seniors aren't very valuable, but we've got a lot of young players on our team, and I think a team that a lot of our conference schools kind of written off in our off season of where we were going to be at to end the year. I've heard it since the end of last season that a lot of teams were going to we were going to take a step back, and these kids stayed to the grindstone. These kids went to work in this off season. We talked all off season about our program is more than just two players, that two or three players we graduated, that it's a program wide, and you know, the expectation of our program is that we're competing for championships every year, and these kids have put themselves in a position to be conference champs for five out of the last 6 years.
Well, Coach, tonight's matchup is against North Iowa, a team that you're seeing for the second time this season. What stands out to you about the Bison?
Well, the first time we played them, they didn't have one of their key players. The Beckler girl, was gone, so we didn't get to see him with their second best player last time we played him, and arguably their best guard was not in the lineup or not even in uniform. So, you know, it's a little different North Iowa team. North Iowa's been playing a lot better basketball, played Lake Mills close the other night. I mean, they've been playing a lot better basketball. They've got the Binken girl inside that's a four-year starter for them, that's a senior, really good 6-foot post player for them that averages almost a double-double. I mean, I think she's like at 10.5 points a game, 10 rebounds a game, so she really hits the boards at a 6-foot frame. She's very athletic. And, you know, Belkler is going to help their guard core from what we saw the first time. I mean, she's a good player. She's been a 2-year starter for them, so they have been playing better basketball. And, you know, we aren't overlooking them one bit. I mean, we worked on nothing but them on yesterday, and our kids are pretty motivated to win this conference outright.
Well, Coach, you'll have this game tonight, obviously, and then a little bit of a layoff before that first playoff game, some time to get a little practice time in and really focus on what you need to work on. But I guess when you look at tonight's game, what do you need to see from the team to say we're ready to just go into the playoffs and we're moving in the right direction?
You know, I just want to see us. We worked a lot yesterday about making the extra pass, moving the ball, working on our guards, getting into a better shooting position. You know, we had talked about Saturday on the coach's show of just, you know, I just think our guards need to be a little smarter on the shot selections we're taking. You know, we've got a tremendous shooting team that hasn't shot it very well lately in the last couple weeks. And, you know, honestly, really since Christmas break, we really shot it that well. And I think some of it comes down to shot selection. I mean, and we talked a lot about that on yesterday in practice, and, you know, becoming a little better, more of a line shooter. Yes, those are open, the deeper shots, you know, when you're feeling it that night. But to start the game, let's get a couple steps in and shoot them line threes. You know, when we do that in practice, when we do that in a game, I mean, we're shooting them at a 40% clip, and we can hit a lot of them. And so just shot selection, you know, it would be a big thing coming forward, making that extra pass to the open shooter, turn a good one into a great one, and, you know, just continue to hit the boards. You know, Abby and Graceland have done a tremendous job on the boards. You know, when they're in the game, it's tough to get second chances, but I challenged our guards a lot and went over different rebounding coverages that we have either out of our zone and man yesterday that we need our guards to defensive rebound better for us, and we need our guards to get more boards for us. So, I mean, those are two areas that I think tonight that we really need to focus on.
That is Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwab with his pregame thoughts. Right now, we'll step aside for a timeout and get you closer to tip-off coming up next on Home Country Radio KLGZ and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle, passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State
Bank. High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast. We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It, they do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric, flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
The starting lineup for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears.
Zoe Montag, junior, number 22.
Garrigan of the steal. Here comes the transition. A sidestep by Montag in the lay-in. Zoe Montag is going crazy right now, and Garrigan's up 81-38.
Emmy Bartolo, sophomore, number 10.
Cross-court feed over to Bartolo. Catches, fires, rattles in a three-pointer.
Tayshia Olish, sophomore, number 24.
Tayshia hangs and passes to the left wing. Olish, three try, and she swished it again. Let Tayshia Olish shoot it.
Gracelyn Eastman, freshman, number 15.
Kicks it out Eastman. Eastman a tray. Eastman knocks it down. First career three-pointer.
Abby Capacious, senior, number 21.
Capacious weaves around traffic, puts it up. She put it in the foul. Abby Capacious for a chance for a three-point play.
Tip-off of your game is coming up next on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
The back-to-back defending state champions back to their normal starting lineup tonight under head coach Brandon Schwab. For North Iowa and head coach Rick Meyer, it'll be the 5'4 junior Aisha Jobe, the 5'7 freshman Bella Langfald, the 5'7 junior Ashlyn Beekler, the 5'4 senior Becca Hoffman, and the 6' senior Miriam Binkin. North Iowa in the home white uniforms, the royal blue trim down the sides and blue numerals on the front and back of the jersey with North Iowa across the front. For Bishop Garrigan, it's the road golds, the black Garrigan across the front, and the black numerals on the front and back of the with black trim down the side of the uniform. At midcourt, Abby Capace for Bishop Garrigan up against Miriam Binkin for North Iowa. Golden Bears 19-2 so far this season, 14-1 in top of Iowa West play. Can they clinch their fifth straight conference title? And we'll find out tonight. The regular season finale is underway. Binkin wins the tip, and we are rolling here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. The Bison will head from right to left on the radio dial as Langfald has the rock to start things off. Flings left to Beekler. As we're 10 seconds into this one, North Iowa this season, 43.3 points per game. That's eighth out of nine teams in the top of Iowa West. Outside, the ball goes towards Binkin. Binkin hooks it up from the foul line, missed it wide right. Jobe tracks in the long rebound. Jobe works the baseline. Jobe up. Jobe missed it. North Iowa almost had a third opportunity, and it's along the baseline and out of bounds. Langfall was bobbling for that ball and stumbling on the baseline and trying to shovel that back into a teammate. But step down as North Iowa comes up empty on their first possession in spite of a couple of opportunities. Here's the Garrigan offense, number three in Class 1A and first in the conference, 63.4 points per game. Some high-low action down to Eastman. Gives right back to Capacious. Capacious floater, good. 2-0 Bishop Garrigan. They went high to low, and then Eastman made a smart play to bring that one back out to Capacious, heading into the lane with some good momentum. As Garrigan presses, North Iowa gets it across half court as it's Binkin into the front court. Binkin, 10.1 points per game, 9.3 rebounds per game for the Bison. As she bounces it into the lane, finds her intended target, and there's a foul. She found Langfald center of the paint, and Garrigan picks up their first foul of this evening. And that foul is going to go against Gracelyn Eastman, her first personal, as Eastman returns to the lineup. Looked very good against West Hancock on Friday night, though. Had the 21 points for the Golden Bears as Langfald heads the charity stripe. A 58% free throw shooter missed on the first one. Well, folks are riding solo here tonight. No Beanie Bodie in this one.
Beanie actually discovered a new element that he's looking to add to the periodic table, and he's actually researching it in his underground lab in Missouri, so obviously he's very busy tonight as Langfall misses the second free throw, and the score stays 2-0 Garrigan. Montag near side, releases the triple, and too strong, that's an air ball. Job has the rebound. Job's going to push. Here she comes into the front court, heads right, and brings the ball back outside. Bounce pass to the right wing as you find Binken. Binken heading left with the dribble, stops the elbow, and Capacious stays in front. Binken turns around as Garrigan plays man-to-man defense early in this game. Top the key to Beekler. Beekler left around the perimeter. Now she starts towards the baseline and gets cut off. Shovels it back outside towards Hoffman. A senior bounce pass back to the junior Beekler with 12 on the shot clock. Beekler heads right around the perimeter. Montag staying in front. Beekler trying to drive against Montag. Beekler pivots, and it's blocked by Zoe Montag. Ball's tied up, and that's going to be a jump ball. Capacious and Job in there as the possession arrow is towards Bishop Garrigan. Beekler was determined to bring that one in against the smaller Montag, trying to power her way to the bucket, but Montag held strong that time, blocked the shot, and another good defensive possession by Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears number 2 in the conference defensively, allowing just 39.1 points per game. Left wing Bartolo lets the three-pointer rip, left it a little short, rebound for Alish. Alish kicks it out, but she kicked it right towards Becca Hoffman for North Iowa. Here comes Hoffman. 2 minutes gone. It's 2-0 Garrigan. Gets it to Binken. Binken threads it into the lane. It got away from Langfall. Went right to Job, though, for the easy two. Langfall was the intended target near side, and then right behind her was Job, and the ball just went right to Job for the easy bucket, and we are locked up at 2 apiece. Allish left side. She'll release a three-pointer, and that one rims out no good. Beekler rebounds near side. She's between two gold jerseys and bounces it away to Binken on the nice wraparound. Binken outlet. Finds Langfall under the bucket. Langfall up a bit. Missed it off to the left, though. Rebound is gotten by North Iowa. Kicks it out to Job. Job along two. That one's no good. And a foul on the rebound. This one's going to go against Bishop Garrigan, their second. Well, a couple things we're looking for early in this game. Garrigan's three-point shooting, it has really struggled the past couple of weeks. And so far tonight, that trend has continued through 3 three-point attempts as the Golden Bears are 0-for-3. Alish picking up her first foul in Melda Hoffman for North Iowa. Job in the corner to Beekler, right back to Job. And the Bison really staying with it rebounding-wise against Garrigan early in this game as well, with a couple second-chance opportunities. Beekler kicks it out towards Job. North Iowa just 7th out of 9 teams in the conference rebounding-wise at 32 per game. As there's the drive, there's the layup. No good by Binken, though. And a rebound by Zoe Montag for Garrigan. Montag with the pace. Montag driving, takes it coast to coast, goes into the body of Binken and draws the foul. A blocking foul by Binken, who never had her feet set, and Zoe Montag is heading to the charity stripe for two. That is such an asset for this Bishop Garrigan team. They have such an athletic, such a fast team, as Coach Meyer of the Bison talked about in the pregame show. They can push the basketball, they can get up and down the floor, and really use that speed to get downhill in a hurry. Montag free throw on the way, and that one rattles into the drain. Zoe Montag, an 80% foul shooter this year for Garrigan, averaging 7.1 points per game in her junior campaign, gives the Golden Bears the early 3-2 advantage at the 5:09 mark of quarter number one. Montag free throw again, good again. 4-2 Bishop Garrigan. Beekler eyeing up the full court press. Gets it right to Hoffman. Hoffman center of the court against Alish. Crosses over and gets into the front court with a nice dribble. Hoffman down the lane, threads the pass down low. It's behind Langfold, though, and out of bounds. Langfold had to pivot the body about 180 on the right side block and just couldn't do it quickly enough to secure that pass. That was trying to guide her away from the interior of the Golden Bear defense. Montag right wing, rotates around to Allish left side. Now Eastman in the high post. Eastman to Montag. Montag catch and shoot from the right wing. Montag swishes it! There's the free ball for Garrigan, and Golden Bears up 7-2 behind 5 points from Zoe Montag so far. Binken handling the dribble. Big-time weapon for North Iowa. A six-footer who can dribble and pass as well as the bounce pass goes down low. Into the paint, Langfall, no good on the layup. Allish trying to track down the rebound. She's in the corner. She's between two white jerseys. Bounces it away and finds Capacious. Picks up a dribble, gets it up ahead to Eastman. They break it. Eastman to the bucket. Eastman layup, up and in. Golden Bears got out of two precarious situations as Allish was trapped in that corner down there but passed it away to Capacious. Then Capacious was kind of pinned on the near sideline but found Eastman in transition, and it's 9-2 Golden Bears. Kickball violation, Bishop Garrigan on the other end, as North Iowa will keep it. The last 7 points going to Bishop Garrigan here as North Iowa brings in the 5'6 freshman Brooklyn Price off the bench as Hoffman will head to the pine. Garrigan brings Murphy in for Eastman. Reagan Murphy, the Golden Bears senior, got the start against West Hancock Friday night. Ball inbound to the Price for North Iowa. Deep on the right wing. 4:07 on the clock here in quarter number one. Here's a deep three-point ball. Beekler, and she guided it off to the left. No good. It's out of bounds and back to Bishop Garrigan. Second matchup between these two teams this season. Golden Bears winning the first one, 71-41, behind 22 points and 8 rebounds by Graceland Eastman. But importantly, no Beekler for North Iowa in that game as Capacious drives in. Capacious layup up and in. split right between white jerseys. Kind of caught North Iowa flat-footed that time because Patience didn't go for the floater. She really drove and attacked the basket. And now Price is going to step out of bounds. Along the far side of the court, Garrigan forced her all the way to the sideline where she tried to tiptoe but could not keep the feet in. And North Iowa turns it over. Turnovers are really the number one thing that hold the Bison back. They're turning it over 24 times per game, the most out of the nine teams in the top of Iowa West. Ball passed into the paint. It tips away from Murphy. She picks it back up, and now the Bison have it. As here comes Binken. Binken runs the floor. Murphy chasing it down. Murphy knocks the ball out of bounds and stops the fast break. Great job by Murphy using that track speed to get back into the play and force the Bison to run an inbounds play from the right side baseline. Eagler. The 5'7 junior looks and gets it into the short corner to Price. Price long jumper, and she swishes it. Price from about 18 feet away knocks down the long two, and it's 11-4 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Price scoring 3.7 points per game off the bench for North Iowa on 21% shooting. Capacious high post. Out to the right to Montag. Montag, three, left that one a little short. Ball's tapped out of bounds. Last touch by Murphy for Garrigan. Langfold had the good inside box out position on the senior Murphy. Now the 5'6 freshman Emma Eichenberger enters the game for North Iowa. Langfald heads to the bench. Eichenberger had a great game last time these two teams matched up. Scored 10 points back on December 19th as Jobe burst into the front court. She's guarded by Bartolo right now. Garrigan has played man-to-man defense coming out in this one as they lead 11-4. Ball's underhanded out to Price. Price for North Iowa on the right side, dribbling against Aulish. 2:54 left in quarter number one. To the top of the key to Binken. Binken right out of the paint. She's driving in. She hangs. She floats. And missed the shot over the top of Capacious. Murphy rebounds near side of the court. Abby Capacious always drawing some big-time defensive assignments when Garrigan goes man-to-man. Montag right side down to the baseline. Capacious. Capacious kicks it out. Bartolo, extra pass to Aulish. Aulish free. Aulish cans it. And Aulish points at Bartolo and says that was a great pass. Bartolo was wide open, but so was Aulish, as Garrigan was unselfish that time, made the extra pass, and they lead by 10, 14-4 off the first three ball by Stacia Aulish. Now Jobe has to get it across and did just before 10 seconds. Binken barreling in, driving baseline, gets the pass into the lane to Eichenberger. Eichenberger right side layup, rolls off the cup, no good. Capacious underneath, rebounds on a foul by Binken. Binken was hanging over Capacious that time for North Iowa's foul. And it comes at the 2:13 mark of quarter number one. Well, North Iowa is not hesitating to take the ball inside against Bishop Garrigan, but they're missing a lot of point-blank layups so far. This is a different game if North Iowa is knocking down more of their layups, but the finishing around the basket has not been good so far for the Bison as Langfald comes in to replace Binken. So can Garrigan continue this push of Binken heading to the bench of two fouls? Langfall, their freshman year, averaging 6.6 points, 4.4 rebounds for North Iowa. Montag, right wing, bounce pass, knocked away. Now it's intercepted by Jobe. Here's Jobe, right down the lane. Jobe stops, floats over Bartolo, missed it right. The box out by Beekler. Beekler put back good. Beekler's the number one scorer on North Iowa. 10.4 points per game and 5.5 rebounds. Had the putback that time. Eastman, the handoff's Capacious in the lane. Capacious rips the ball away. Hershock blocks, though. Bison play good interior rim protection that time. And now here comes North Iowa. Eichenberger into the front court. Gets it left side to Beekler. Beekler, catch and shoot three. Almost banked that one in. Offensive board, though, for the Bison underneath the bucket. Price gets it into Eichenberger. Eichenberger in the paint. Wants to get it back outside to Beekler, top of the key. And... ooh, 3 second call, North Iowa. They got called for hanging out in the lane that time, and they will turn it over. So Bison come up empty on that possession, and Garrigan continues to lead 14-6 here in quarter number one. North Iowa 7-13 so far this season. Their most wins since going 14-10 back in the 2013-2014 season, so they made a lot of improvements in having their best season in quite some time right now. They won six games last year, then a combined six the 4 years before that, so... Bison have been pointing upwards lately as Garrigan will travel and turn it over. Alyssa Hoagland getting her first run of the ball game for the Golden Bears. Aulish will check in for Bartolo right now, and Murphy in for Capacious at the 1:18 mark of quarter number one. Quick moving first quarter so far as Beekler for the baseline calling for her teammates to come help her and come get the basketball. She inbounds the basketball to Price. Price working against Murphy. Murphy with the poke away. Price tiptoes the sideline. She probably should have let that one go out, but she ends up getting it up ahead to Eichenberger. Eichenberger in the front court for North Iowa. 1:04 left in the first quarter. Now it's Beekler. Beekler works the baseline. Beekler reverse. Beekler missed it too strong, and Eastman grabs another rebound. Eastman so far of 10 double-doubles this season. Had one against West Hancock Friday night.
as Aulish had the ball dislodged, got it out to Montag. Montag trying to rip it away and keep it safe from Price, who was going for that one, into Eastman among three jerseys. She pivots, she puts it up, and she puts it in! Eastman pivoted away from trouble that time, and Langfold fell down for North Iowa. Otherwise, that's a much tougher shot, but because Langfold fell down, Eastman had the wide open two. But four white jerseys around her, and she scored anyways. Job in the lane, shovels it right side towards Eichenberger, gets it underneath. Layup up and good for Langfold. 16-8, Bishop Garrigan, 22 seconds left in the first as Aulish inbounds towards Montag. Montag will bring it across the Bison script at half court as we're down to 13 seconds left in the first period. Golden Bears going for their fifth conference title in a row, up 16-8 in quarter number one. Down to the baseline, Murphy into Eastman, makes the catch, finishes on the layup. Eastman snatching that basketball out of the air. 2 seconds, 1 second, Beekler. Three-quarter court heave is no good and off to the left, and that is the end of quarter number one. Bishop Garrigan up by 10. It's 18-8 as we head to the second on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, when you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Regular season finale here on Home Country Radio, KLGZ Algona. It's 18-8 in favor of Bishop Garrigan as they lead the North Iowa Bison here in Buffalo Center. Bison have the basketball heading from right to left on the radio dial. It'll start at the second quarter. I'm Tyler Lance flying solo tonight. Nobody Bodie as Beekler has the basketball for North Iowa. Backs her way in, and her turnaround is blocked by Zoe Montag. Capacious outlets towards Bartolo right side. Now to Aulish. Aulish the trailer. Rises for three. She swishes it. Sasha Aulish from downtown. Now here comes the Garrigan press. As we said, no Beanie Bodie tonight, though, as Beanie is training for the Nathan's hot dog eating contest, and tonight is a major loading night for Beanie. No one can put down a hot dog like Beanie Bodie as there's a drive and a foul. Becca Hoffman is heading to the charity stripe for two shots. But who knows how many of those Beanie will be eating while he watches this broadcast from the safe confines of his lab in Missouri. Two free throws coming for Hoffman, who's struggled the line so far this season. 25% from the stripe, but buries the first one. And that'll make it 21-9 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. One thing North Iowa has tended to do so far in this game, they'll get the ball underneath, they'll get it down onto the block, but then they're not really going up strong with the ball. They're kind of fading back into some tougher shots. And there's a offensive rebound by Langfold tracking down the missed free throw, and North Iowa keeps the possession. Job right side, but they can maybe draw some fouls against Garrigan if you go up a little bit stronger rather than fading back on each layup attempt. Job, right side, three-point ball. Job swishes it. Big three-pointer for North Iowa as Job knocks it down and makes it 21-12. Bison this year, about a 21% three-point shooting team. That is eighth out of nine teams in the conference. The ball is dislodged from Eastman in the high post. Bison very active on defense so far. Aggressively going for steals. Here comes Beekler the other way. Beekler spinning into the paint, spun right into Eastman. Layup no good. Offensive board for Binken, though. Works around Capacious, floats it over the top. Ball swirls out of the cup, no good. And Capacious boxes out for the rebound. Outlet up to Aulish, makes the catch. Aulish sails in. Aulish fouled, and she put it in. Chance for a three-point play by the Bishop Garrigan sophomore, and it's 23-12 Golden Bears. Well, we talk all the time, game after game, about how good Abby Capacious is rebounding-wise, but the thing we don't talk about a lot, how good she is about looking for that outlet pass as soon as she rebounds, because she knows one of the guards is heading down the floor for a layup just like Aulish just had. And that's why Capacious is averaging over three assists per game as Aulish's free throw swishes. 24-12 as Bishop Garrigan right now doubling up North Iowa. All of a sudden, 9 points by Sasha Aulish leading the way for the Golden Bears. Her season average 10.8 as Golden Bears almost out of steal. Binken right side bounce pass towards the lane. It rolls out of bounds and last touched by North Iowa. Bison were calling for a kickball violation against the Golden Bears, but they won't get it. They were trying to find Langfold posting up down on the far side block. Now it's Bartolo.
number two in the conference in assists per game. Running point. Allish back to Bartolo. Almost had that pass jumped as Alexis Gray, the freshman, tried to jump it. Kemna, three-point ball from the left side. No good as Reese Kemna can't knock it down. Eastman grabs a loose ball under the bucket. Her putback is no good. And Langfall secures the rebound for North Iowa. 24-12, Bishop Garrigan. Approaching the six-minute mark of quarter number two as the Golden Bears look for the season sweep and their 20th win of the season. Binken looking underneath for Langfald. The knockaway, though, by Eastman. Nice job keeping her body on Langfald and not letting the freshman get away as Allish brings it into the front court. Goes left corner to Capacious. Long two on the way. Her foot was on the line, but she airballed it. And a rebound by Beekler for North Iowa. Beekler's their second leading rebounder behind Binken as down the floor, leaking out and scoring is Alexis Gray. Golden Bears lost track of Gray that time, and it's 24-14 as the North Iowa freshman puts her first 2 points of the board on the night. 10-point advantage for Garrigan. Eastman high post, looks left to Allish. On the wing, she'll cue up a three-point try, and it rattles into the cup! Another free ball by Sasha Allish. She has the hot hand early for Garrigan. 12 points for the sophomore. 27-14 Golden Bears. Beekler heads right in between the circles for North Iowa. Surveyed by Emmy Bartolo. Now up top, it's Binken. Binken, a great post player for North Iowa, but also a good passer as well. And ball goes underneath, layup no good for the Bison. Eastman boxes off for the rebound, looks for the outlet to Allish. Eastman's arm got hit as she was throwing that. That pass came up a little short, but Allish caught it anyways. And then Allish fouled as she controls the ball in the front court. North Iowa picking that one up with Beekler, her second. And the Bison now have two fouls this quarter as Reese Kemna heads to the bench. Alyssa Hoagland in for Bishop Garrigan. Hoffman to the pine for North Iowa as Price re-enters the ball game. Bartolo passing right side towards Allish. Bison play a 2-3 zone defense, but they're pretty aggressive and pretty active in that zone as Eastman catches, and there's another foul by North Iowa. That is their third of the quarter. And that foul will go against Gray, her first personal. A lot of what the Bison can do offensively, though, may come in transition because they're a team that gets a lot of steals. 14 steals per game, so some opportunities to run as the pass in is going to be tied up for a jump ball. That's Capacious and Binken getting tied up. Allish was trying to find Capacious, cherry-picking under the bucket for the easy two, but Binken saw that one coming and forced the tie-up as Garrigan keeps it. Allish to the bench. Hoagland is going to be the inbounder for Bishop Garrigan as Hoagland has it from the right side baseline. Looking inside for Capacious. Ball knocked away. Capacious trying to force a tie-up again, and she does. Possession to go back to North Iowa, though. That was good team defense on Capacious. She was kind of leaning into Binken that time, but Price from the opposite side. Binken was on the left side. Price was on the right side of Capacious, and it was Price from that right side just snaking the arm around and knocking it away to prevent that clean inbounds pass to the physical Capacious under the bucket. 27-14, Garrigan. Binken works across the foul line, looks underneath. Langfald catches on the left block and kicks it out to Price. Price, top of the key, can't find the step back, so she'll go right to Job. Job heads around the screen. Job on the right wing now, 4:28 left in the quarter. Curling around is Gray. Gray drives in. Gray all the way to the block, takes up a tough shot, no good, and Eastman rebounds on the right side of the paint. Eastman brings the ball up into the front court. She's averaging 9.7 rebounds per game and tries to find her position down in the low post against Binken. Right corner, Capacious, looking inside for Eastman. Binken fronts her, though. Capacious drives baseline, passes the corner to Bartolo, rotates to Hoagland. Left wing three-pointer, off the heel, no good. And a rebound by Binken in the lane. And now here comes the senior on the sprint. Binken running the floor. The poke away by Bartolo. Ball's loose. Gold jersey's on top of it, and Bartolo rips it off the ground. Montag will have the ball now for Garrigan, and a timeout called by Coach Schwab. 30-second timeout with 3:55 left in the second quarter. And that'll be the first timeout taken by either side so far in this game. Not a whole lot of breaks in this one. Really not a whole lot of fouls as both teams have looked to push the pace here, get out and run, and move in transition. And that's created a fast-paced ball game so far as Garrigan has the 27-14 lead. Well, as always, we thank our presenting sponsors here on the Algona Radio YouTube stream, Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Kemna Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. PMC Advantage Insurance Services, where having the advantage makes all the difference. Algona Frame and Auto Body, where we meet by accident. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona. And Algona Municipal Utilities, community-owned for community benefit. Our video streaming sponsors all throughout the season. As we wind it down the regular season, final game for Garrigan here in this regular season before the playoffs roll around next week for both the boys and girls squads. Bartolo across half court finding Montag. Garrigan may play North Iowa in that first round of the playoffs. They'll play the winner of North Iowa against West Hancock. The Bison and the Eagles will tangle on Thursday night. Capacious passes right corner to Montag. Open three-point try, and Montag buries it! 30-14, Bishop Garrigan. That is 8 points by Zoe Montag. Golden Bears still haven't been super hot on threes so far in this game, but they are taking good looks and knocking a few of them down. Three-pointed the other way, North Iowa. Price no good. Rebound by Job. Job puts it up, and Job missed the follow. Ball gets tapped out, and Capacious has it. Wants to run the floor, but she'll be fouled. That foul will prevent the runout, that is, by Capacious, as Price picks that up. I'll tell you what, Job checks in at 5'4", but she's already had three or four offensive rebounds tonight. That is a guard who's not afraid to get underneath the bucket and bang around underneath the likes of Eastman and Capacious for Garrigan, who really take up a lot of the rebounds. But Job for North Iowa has gotten us up a couple second chance opportunities so far tonight. Right side to Montag for Garrigan. Now down to the baseline, Capacious right side. Pass towards Eastman, knocked out of bounds. Bison are doing a really good job of preventing the ball from going inside to Eastman, who has 6 points so far tonight. It's a team effort. Of course, you have the 6-foot-tall post player Binken, but it's not just her. It's really a team effort. They're trying to double team her right now and put her in a sandwich. In the corner to Hoagland, releases on the three-point ball, too strong. It's out of bounds, and it's off the hands of Eichenberger as she couldn't secure the uncontested rebound. Garrigan gets a break as they'll keep it. But they were putting Eastman in a sandwich. It was Langfold on the backside and Beekler on the front side, and then Beekler also had that right corner covered as well. She tried to close out on Hoagland. Now it's Emmy Bartolo from the left corner. Her three-point ball off the front of the cup, and Beekler rebounds near side. Here's a runout for North Iowa. It's Beekler, left of the bucket. Beekler takes a wide angle, and she spun it off the rim, no good. Got her on this back, put up it good. 30-16 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. That's 4 points by Beekler so far. She got the put back there. 2:39 left in the half. Montag into Capacious. Capacious into traffic, and she shuffled the shoes. Those white jerseys holding strong in the paint, and Capacious ends up traveling and turning it over for Garrigan. North Iowa has Hoffman back into the ball game as Price goes to the pine. Job will bring it across half court as we're hitting the 2.5 minute mark of quarter number two. Job, top of the key. Looks left and bounces it over to Hoffman. Hoffman takes a couple dribbles towards the right side. Bartolo almost had the steal. Hoffman spins away from her, keeps that pivot foot, down to the baseline to Beekler. Beekler goes in against Capacious. Beekler up and good. Nice patient drive that time by Beekler. Kept Capacious behind her. Used the body to block off that Bishop Garrigan senior, and it's 30-18. 12-point lead right now by the Golden Bears as North Iowa won't go away here in the first half. Eastman barrels away inside. Eastman draws the foul. Two free throws coming as Langfall tries to stay in front of Eastman, but the foul's going to go against Beekler, and that's big for North Iowa. That is number three against Beekler, and that is the 15th foul against the Bison coming at the 2:02 mark of quarter number two. Eastman will shoot free throws in front of the open side of the gym. Above where the basket is, it's actually a big open room. You can probably see it on the video stream as Eastman knocks down the free throw where some students are sitting in right now. I really think North Iowa is missing an opportunity by not having the student section up in that open room behind the opposing bucket. You could really create a big distraction there at the student section as Eastman knocks down the free throw whenever the opposing team is going that way. But instead, just an empty classroom back there as Eastman hits both free throws. She has 8 points, and Garrigan up 32-18. Binken in the backcourt. Binken has to hurry. Binken wings it across. She got it across half court. Langfold in the post. Her pass knocked away by Eastman. It goes back towards Langfold. She dives on top of it, and that'll be a tie-up. Eastman and Langfold. Langfold was trying to zip that pass right across the paint, find one of her trailing teammates in transition that time, but Eastman just got her mitts up in front of that, knocked that ball straight down. Possession arrow towards Garrigan as they get the ball back after the jump ball. 1:42 left in the first half. 32-18, Bishop Garrigan looking for conference title number 5 in a row. They can do it tonight for a win, and they could do it outright. Bartolo deep on the wing, gets it cornered to Capacious. Wings it across near side towards Aulish. Now to Montag. Montag, deep three-pointer from the right side. That one misses. Offensive board, Capacious. Kicks out to Bartolo. Catch and shoot three, and she splashes it. Emmy Bartolo makes it 35-18. That is her first field goal of the night. Bartolo came in at number three in the conference on three-point percentage for the top of Iowa West. Now Job right side. Head fakes, drives, floats, and Job knocks it down. Job from mid-range. It's 35-20 in favor of Garrigan as Job has 7 points for North Iowa, leading the way so far in this game. Aulish, three-point ball blocked. It's rejected by Langfold. North Iowa tries to outlet it, but Bartolo chases down the outlet pass in the backcourt. Bartolo flings it back up ahead to Montag. It's off her hands. It's going out of bounds with 51 seconds left in the first half. Things are getting a little sloppy the last minute or so as both teams really look to turn up the pace. Eastman checking out. Aulish checking out for Garrigan. Kemna and Murphy checking in. Bishop Garrigan came into tonight having taken 500 three-pointers so far this season. They attempted 523 of those last year in 27 games. This is just Garrigan's 22nd game, though, as there's a free ball from the left side. No good by Hoffman. An air ball. Rebound in the lane. Eichenberger pivots around and puts it back in. 35-22 as Eichenberger has her first field goal. And now the shot clock and game clock are virtually even for Bishop Garrigan. Down to 28 on the game clock as Bartolo dribbles just inside of half court. Right side to Kemna. Now back out to Bartolo. Left to Capacious with 20 seconds left in the first half. Bartolo and Capacious go back and forth as they shift around the Bison 2-3 zone. And this will be a timeout called by Bishop Garrigan. They will take a 60-second timeout with 14.4 seconds left here in the first half and a 35-22 advantage by Bishop Garrigan in this ball game. Well, final seconds running down before halftime. As we said, the season's starting to run out here, at least the regular season anyway. Certainly the Golden Bears hoping for another magical playoff run, as right now they're ranked at the number 6 spot in Class 1A. North Lynn has held that top spot in the rankings all throughout the season, and Newell Fonda checking at the number 2 spot right now. But all that gets thrown out the window once tournament time rolls around. As we said, North Iowa plays their opening playoff game at West Hancock on Thursday night. Winner in that game will play Bishop Garrigan in the next postseason game coming up next week. And then after that, we'll see what happens. It'll be an interesting run from there. Should Garrigan win in their opening postseason matchup, they would potentially see a team from the top of Iowa east of St. Ansgar and Newman Catholic on that side of the bracket as well. So a lot to be decided still here in postseason action. As we'll talk about a little later, the boys' postseason brackets for districts just came out as well. So we'll talk about that a bit during the boys' game, what those matchups look like. But the postseason picture really clarifying here the past couple of days as we're down to the final 14 seconds of the first half. Bishop Garrigan takes that timeout, wanting a really good possession here before halftime. Working on those late game and late half situations. Capacious gets the inbounds towards Bartolo, and we're down to 12 seconds. Montag back to Bartolo. Bartolo heads towards the right side, finds Alsh of 7. Alsh down to the baseline to Capacious. It's off her foot, though, and it's out of bounds with 5.4 seconds. So North Iowa will have a chance to try to get the ball up the court and get something off here before halftime. 5.4 seconds into Job. Job, full head of steam, brings it across half court. Job with 1 second. Job from the logo, lets it fly. Missed it off to the right, no good. Not a bad look for Job that time. She was expecting a little more pressure and then got moving laterally instead of up and down the court. But in any case, Bishop Garrigan will take the lead into halftime, 35-22 at the half, as we'll step aside for a timeout and come back with more next on Home Country Radio KLGZ and the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
As we come back here at halftime on Home Country Radio KLGZ, the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears lead the North Iowa Bison 35-22. Right now we're going to check in with boys coach Mark Meister and preview the action coming up in that ball game. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time here at halftime. Let's first flash back to Friday night as you guys were able to defeat West Hancock 65-30 in that ball game. So, you know, Friday night, obviously a good performance by the team. What were a couple big things that stood out to you?
Our defense collectively as a group, I thought Trayton Sink did a heck of a job on their best player, that Smith kid. We kind of didn't allow him to do as much. We ran a double at him off a few of their shooters that weren't shooting as well, and we were able to execute that really well and held them to 30. We were really happy with that. That was kind of our goal was, you know, can we hold them 10 under their scoring? And, well, we ended up doing better than that, so it worked out well for us.
Well, Coach, a big trend recently for Bishop Garrigan has been holding opposing teams under their season averages and having some really solid defensive performances start to pile up. So how have you seen things come together on the defensive side as far as just what you feel is driving that improvement as the year goes on?
I think we've gotten cleaner with what we're doing and the rotational things we're trying to do. And certain guys out there, I think some of the chemistry has kind of started to gel with a few of the guys and different rotations we're running now. Some of the groups that we're subbing are doing a better job when they're coming in, understanding what we're supposed to do. We used to get, you know, kind of lost in some of the minutes, and guys come in and they're not sure. You know, it only takes one guy with some of the defenses we try to run to kind of mess it up. So chemistry has really picked up on that end of the floor, and I think maybe a little bit more sense of pride and, you know, meaningfulness moving forward that, you know, when winning tournaments games is going to take getting stops and getting out and running.
And, Coach, of course, the team's adjusted their lineup as time's gone on. I know, you know, in a couple of the recent games, you've had two bigs in the starting lineup with Nemers and Lear. What do you feel that, I guess, dimension of the lineup has brought to you guys?
Well, I thought they've been playing really well and really well together. Lear's been, you know, kind of on a tear the last five games. He's almost averaging a double-double. So we saw, you know, he needed some more time on the floor with the rebounding and the scoring. He gets a lot of extra possessions for us. I mean, a tip, a steal, he's been doing a lot of that stuff. And then it's kind of freed it up more for Nimmers, even though we still don't think we get him the ball enough. But, you know, Lear's commanding a lot of attention on that side of the paint if he's on opposite blocks. So Logan's been able to do some more things on his side operating. So they've been tough, both of them equally, I've felt.
Well, Coach, you go into tonight's matchup against North Iowa, wrapping up the regular season and seeing the Bison for the second time. What are a couple of things that jump out to you when you look at North Iowa?
Well, they got one of their better players back, so they're a different team right now than what they were the first time we played them. They played Eagle Grove here pretty tough. That was tight for quite a while, and then they kind of lost it as Eagle Grove cranked up the defensive side of it and kind of trapping and pressing. So those are kind of some of the things we're going to try and do to make them handle the ball and make decisions. So hopefully we can execute that.
Coach, along those same lines, what do you feel the biggest key for Bishop Garrigan is tonight?
Well, kind of that, and then getting out and not getting ahead of ourselves on the break. You know, we've got some guys that are doing some really nice things defensively, and they're getting out, and we're telling them to take those layups and, you know, not settle for bad shots. So if I think we do that, it should be a good game for us.
You know, Coach, as we wind down here, obviously the Boys High School Athletic Association released their district assignments today. I guess, did you get a chance to look at that, and what was your reaction to seeing where your team was assigned?
I did. I was pretty happy. You know, obviously I would have preferred maybe the North Union on our side, not the Lake Mills, but we wanted the two seed. We felt we had played well enough. You know, we had given a few games away late, so we were a little concerned if we were going to slide down a little bit, but happy with the two seed, you know, get a couple home games and hopefully some winnable games for us. So I feel pretty good about it overall.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
All right, thanks for having me.
That is Bishop Garrigan Boys Basketball Coach Mark Meister stopping by here at halftime on Home Country Radio KLGZ. Right now, a timeout and the second half of girls basketball action coming up in 5 minutes on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Fulth, and Michael Toth.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance Agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Time here on Home Country Radio KLGZ and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears lead the North Iowa Bison 35-22 at the half here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. Our video is streaming on the Algona Radio YouTube page, brought to you by Iowa State Bank, helping people succeed. Chemna Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care. PMC Advantage Insurance Services, where having the advantage makes all the difference. Algona Frame and Auto Body, leave me by accident. Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community
benefit. Again, at the half, it's 35-22 in favor of Bishop Garrigan as the Golden Bears try for their 20th win of the season and an outright conference title. They can get both of those if they win tonight in this regular season finale against North Iowa. Scoring-wise, the Golden Bears had the scoring edge in the first quarter, 18-8 over the Bison, then had a 17-14 scoring advantage in the second quarter to bring this 35-22 lead into halftime. Overall, I'd say this game hasn't been quite as crisp or as clean as Bishop Garrigan might have wanted it to be so far. They are starting to knock down a few three-pointers or getting some open looks there, but the fact that both the Golden Bears and the Bison want to push the plays, play fast, get out in transition, that's kind of gotten Bishop Garrigan into maybe a little bit more of a sloppy kind of game and a little bit more of a chaotic kind of game with the way the Bison have been so aggressive on defense, just trying to double-team Eastman inside, really trying to poke the ball away from the Garrigan ball handlers, trying to jump passes when possible. So I think that they've been a little chaotic so far today in Buffalo Center, Iowa, as both teams have probably had more turnovers than they'd like to see so far in this one. But ultimately, Golden Bears on top right now, 35-22, getting that faster play style of the North Iowa Bison. And really, for North Iowa, I'd say the big thing to improve in the second half, clean up a lot of those point-blank misses. I mean, this is probably a single-digit game right now if the Bison make a few more of those layups. They are getting the basketball inside against the Golden Bears, but they're either fading away and creating tougher shots or trying to shoot through vertical Golden Bear defenders, and they're missing shots. They're getting offensive rebound opportunities, but the putbacks aren't going either. So there have been a lot of missed points in the paint tonight so far by the Bison, and sometimes it's as simple as that. You can get good shots, you can get looks you like, you can get offensive rebound, but if you don't put the ball in the basket, you're not going to be winning at halftime. And right now the Bison are down 35-22. Shooting-wise this season, you can kind of see it. I mean, they're a team that shoots only about 31.5% from the field, which is 7th out of 9 teams in the conference. So it seems like this has been an issue at times this year for the Bison, but just more of a clean performance as far as getting those point-blank shots, those points in the paint for the Bison should really help as we go into the second half. So 35-22 Bishop Garrigan, one final timeout, then the second half of basketball action coming up next on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Start of the second half here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. Tyler Lance riding solo tonight as Bishop Garrigan leads North Iowa 35-22 right now. No Beanie Bodie tonight as he's busy right now in his lab listening to every song by Olivia Rodrigo start to finish. Beanie's a big Olivia Rodrigo fan, so he was busy with that so far tonight. Right now, it's North Iowa for the basketball, heading from left to right on the radio dial. It's Hoffman in the short right corner, pivots around, ball getting poked at by Sasha Arlish for Bishop Garrigan. Hoffman around the perimeter, Arlish stays right with her, looking to pass it into the lane, finding Buechler left side. Buechler gets past Montag, Buechler shot up, off the back of the cup, no good. The rebound by Eastman, and once again, North Iowa still not getting the offensive putbacks, as now this is going to be a turnover. So Garrigan will get the possession here, 35-22. Bartolo will bring it into the front court. As Bartolo had 3 points in the first half, Sasha Arlish leading the way of 12 for the Golden Bears as Arlish has it left wing. Top of the key to Bartolo. Bartolo kicks out to Montag. Montag looks inside Eastman. Hard pass. Eastman makes a tough catch. Can't put it in, though. Left the layup short. Ball's loose in the paint. That is going to be a tie-up. Hoffman and Capacious getting tied up inside. Boy, what a grab by Eastman. Just stuck that bear paw out because Montag threw a 90-mile-per-hour bullet down to the post, trying to find Eastman and prevent that aggressive Bison defense from knocking the pass away. But ultimately, no good on the layup, and the Bison end up forcing a tie-up. Job heading left to right on the radio dial. 7:12 left here in the third quarter as Job picks up a dribble in between the circles and gets it right to Binken. Quiet first half by Binken, 2 fouls and 0 points. Binken, the second leading scorer on the team behind Buechler. Buechler at 6 in the first half. Buechler catches along the baseline, underhands it to Langfald. Langfald layup no good. Langfald putback also no good, but she got fouled. 2 free throws coming for North Iowa as Langfald will head to the stripe. Langfald scored 17 points, first time these teams matched up back on December 19th. She was the leading scorer for the Bison in that game. Langfald taking the third most free throw attempts per game in the conference at 4.9. The freshman inserting her way into the North Iowa starting lineup this year. And she'll tee up the first free throw, and that one rattles around the cup and drops through. 35-23 as North Iowa draws the first blood of the second half. Bison trying to win their 8th game of the season as North Iowa right now has their most wins since going
14-10 back in the 2013-2014 season. Capacious, the contested rebound off the missed free throw, and here she comes. Full head of steam, gets it right side to Montag, fakes one way, drives across the foul line. Montag into the corner towards Bartolo. Bartolo wings it into Eastman. Fingertip catch, works towards the right side. Eastman powers it up, and she drew the foul. Couldn't quite spin that in, but Eastman was shooting two from the charity stripe. And getting those inside touches to Eastman, such a central part of the Bishop Garrigan offense. North Iowa, in spite of maybe not having a ton of size, they do have the 6-foot Binken, but besides her, really not a ton of height on this North Iowa team. They made it tough to get Eastman clean touches inside as Eastman knocks down the free throw, and it now has 9 points. But Eastman taking the second most free throw attempts per game in the conference, just under 6 per game. She knocks the second one down as well. 2 points on the board for Garrigan, and a 37-23 lead as Eastman into double figures of 10 points. Shooting at about a 63.5% clip on free throws this season. Beekler picks up a dribble at the top of the key for North Iowa, pivots around and passes it over to the left to Hoffman. Hoffman bouncing it into the post. It's Langfall, tries to shield off Eastman. Shot no good, though. It hit off the side of the rim. Eastman rebounds. Eastman got tripped up, and she traveled. That was a nice job by North Iowa. They had two white jerseys surrounding Eastman that time. Made it tough to escape from there, and they did a nice job of not reaching in and committing that foul. Not getting in front and blocking either as Job tries to drive across Aulish. She blows a tire. Now here comes Garrigan. Bartolo on the run out. Bartolo layup. Up and in. 39-23, Bishop Garrigan. This Golden Bear defense just so opportunistic against the Bison team that have struggled with turnovers so far this season. This North Iowa team is the team that turns it over most in the conference. Garrigan turns it over the least in the conference as Langfall doesn't see any room against Eastman to maneuver. Gets it out to Beekler. Beekler works the baseline. Tries to reverse. Blocked by Montag, but a foul. Beekler is going to shoot 2 free throws. Beekler is the number one free throw shooter on North Iowa. 66.7% from the line so far this season. Scoring 10.4 points per game. Also leading the team. As Beekler will shoot 2 here. First one, line drive, no good. Well, Bishop Garrigan is normally used to dominating the rebounding edge in a game, but North Iowa's gotten a fair share of second-chance opportunities so far in this one, and really the first time these teams matched up, the rebounding was pretty even. Garrigan had a 27-22 advantage as Beekler drains the free throw to give her 7 points. But North Iowa is really scrappy on the boards as well. They're really trying to crash the glass hard and get second-chance opportunities on the offensive end. Bartolo passing right towards Montag. Montag down to the baseline. Capacious sees an opening. Kicks out to Bartolo. Extra pass to Montag. Looks right to Aulish. Finds her deep on the wing. Flips it to Capacious in the high post. Looking inside to Eastman. Works around Binken. Back to Eastman. Edge of the paint. Takes a power dribble. Barrels into traffic. Layup no good. Capacious cleanup. Her putback's no good. And Binken at the rebound in the center of the paint. Binken was doing everything that defensive possession. Was defending Capacious and then was rebounding later on as she dribbles near the top of the key right now. Binken fires down to the block to Langfeld. Langfeld over Eastman. Shot up and in. That's a powerful move by the 5'7 Langfeld going up against Eastman, who stands at about 6 feet tall. That's 5 points by Langfeld and a 39-26 score right now. Bartolo looking inside to Eastman. Knocked away as Binken was fronting her, and Binken secures the basketball. Here she comes into the front court, passing it up ahead to Hoffman. Hoffman sees an opening, takes it to the rack, and scores it. North Iowa trying to get back into this one. It's an 11-point game right now. That's 3 points by Hoffman. 39-28. Montag near side rotates to Aulish. Top of the key, steps into a 3-point try, and Aulish swishes it. The big response by Sasha Aulish. She has 15 points so far tonight, leading both sides. 42-28, Bishop Garrigan. It's Binken near the top of the key. Aulish poking at the basketball. Binken, foul line jumper, off the back of the cup. Got her on this back, looking to pass down to Beekler. Beekler, layup up and in. That is a great find by Binken. She's averaging 2.7 assists per game, which is great for a big. And passes like that are why. Bartolo, 3 on the other end. Missed it off to the right. Loose rebound collected by Binken. North Iowa starting to force Bishop Garrigan to go one and done offensively in the second half. This is helping them try to get it down to a single-digit deficit. Right now down by 12. Binken on the right elbow gets it out to Beekler. Beekler from way downtown. And she rattles it in. Beekler makes it a 9-point game. She has 12 points on the scoreboard, and all of a sudden, North Iowa is making Bishop Garrigan sweat a little bit here in the third quarter. 42-33. Aulish left wing gets to top of the key towards Bartolo. Now high post to Eastman. Drives her way in, finds Capacious right baseline. Capacious across the paint, kicks it out to Aulish. Catch and shoot 3. In and out, no good. And Binken off the rebound. North Iowa trying to continue this push. They were down at halftime, 35-22.
and they've gotten back into it. Beekler, another three-point try. Missed it off to the left, and Capacious forces North Iowa to be one and done. Outreach Job that time for the rebound. Wings it up ahead, but throws an interception. Here comes Beekler running the floor against Capacious. Capacious knocks the ball away. Ball's heading towards the perimeter. Beekler dives on top of it. Oh, she threw it off of Montag. What a play by Beekler. Capacious had her in a wrestling position that time. Beekler was flat on her stomach, nowhere to go, and somehow, with the ball on the floor, reached that right hand out, just sort of swept the ball off of Montag's leg. That was a heads-up play by Beekler. Gets it into Binken. Foul line jumper, and she got hit. Binken's going to shoot two free throws. All the momentum on the North Iowa side right now is Binken's going to be shooting two. She's just under 57% from the foul line so far this season. Well, Binken is in pretty rare company when it comes to the top of Iowa West. Only Binken, as well as Gracelyn Eastman and Abby Capacious, are averaging at least 10 points per game and at least 9 rebounds per game as well. So it's just those three as she knocks down the foul shot. That is her first point of the night, and it's 42-34. Well, if you told North Iowa they'd only be down right now by 8 points, with Binken only having one on the board, I think they'd be okay with that, because they know at some point Binken is likely going to start scoring a little more as the second free throw in and out, and Capacious sails in for the rebound. 3:05 left in the third quarter. Garrigan needing a bucket right now. Up to the top towards Bartolo. Foul line to Capacious. Pivots around. Nothing there. Around the perimeter towards Hoagland. Right side free. She head fakes. Out towards Montag. Now foul line Capacious. Drives in. Knock away by Job. Ball rolls out towards Hoagland, and Job runs her over. Boy, that was going to be a jump ball, but that ball got to Hoagland about a quarter of a second before Job did, and Job just kind of bowled Hoagland over that time. That will be foul number three against North Iowa. But those are the kind of risks you have to take defensively against Garrigan, being aggressive as they were. Reagan Murphy in right now for Garrigan. Eastman coming back in as Capacious checks out. And I like the fact that Coach Schwab is not calling a timeout here. He's trying to force his team to work through a tough stretch, as they will have to in the playoffs at some point. Hoagland to the foul line to Eastman. Gets it near side towards Montag. The three-pointer's cut off, and she shuffled the shoes. Binken was barreling down on the closeout, and Montag sort of pitter-patter the feet that time. She wanted to drive. She wanted to pass. Tried to do both at the same time. And Bishop Garrigan all of a sudden having trouble hanging onto the ball offensively. Job just to the right of center, surveying the 2-3 zone defense right now by Garrigan. 2:35 left in the third quarter. Beekler pivoting around and flinging it left side as she'll find it. Price. Price out to Job, eyes the bucket, starts to drive, flings it across to Beekler. Beekler drives baseline, floats it over Eastman, up and good! 14 points by Beekler, and the charge continues by the Bison. It's 42-36. Beekler is taking over this third quarter. 2:14 left, as Bishop Garrigan's lead is down to 6 points right now. Eastman in the high post. Eastman looking out towards Hoagland from the right side corner. Hoagland free ball, too strong, and Beekler grabs the rebound. Beekler takes it herself across half court, picked up by Hoagland. Garrigan's going to stay back in the 2-3 zone. Job on the wing. Job fires a three, way too strong as it heads out of bounds. That's an air ball as it will go back to Bishop Garrigan. It's a quick shot by North Iowa as Beekler heads to the bench. Checking in will be Becca Hoffman. Remember, Beekler does have 3 fouls, so North Iowa does not want Beekler to pick up that fourth in the final 1:51 of this third quarter. And they're hoping they can play about even if Garrigan going into the fourth, keep it at right about a 6-point game. Montag gets it top of the key towards Bartolo. High post to Capacious. Quick pass out to Hoagland. She'll try again. Left the three-pointer short. Capacious taps it out to Montag. That won't go down as a rebound for Capacious, but that essentially is an offensive rebound. High post Capacious. Pivots around and gets it out to Montag. Deep three-pointer from the right side. Missed it left. Murphy had it briefly, but the rebound pinballs out to Bartolo. And a third opportunity for Bishop Garrigan. Capacious over to Hoagland with 1:22 left in the third quarter. Bartolo back towards Hoagland, all the way to the right to Montag in the corner. Fakes baseline, drives in, Montag sweeps the layup up, draws the foul. 2 free throws coming by Zoe Montag. Well, this will at least give Bishop Garrigan a chance to take a deep breath. Zoe Montag, an 80% free throw shooter, heading to the foul line. Garrigan is a team just over 69% for the foul line this season. Number one in the top of Iowa West and number three in Class 1A is Montag. Sitting on 8 points right now, all those in the first half. And now she has 9 as she knocks down the free throw. 43-36 in favor of Garrigan. Job will go to the bench. Gray will check in for North Iowa. Also going to the bench is Eichenberger. As Binken on the floor right now for the Bison. Second free throw up and good. Langfold also on the floor. 44-36 is Zoe Montag right now with 10 points for Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears in front, but the Bison have been charging hard in this third quarter. Down low, the Langfold catches against Capacious, and Capacious almost had the knockaway. They got it out to Gray. Gray jumper, no good, and Murphy rebounds on the near side. Bison were yelling for a foul that time, but they won't get it. And now 55 seconds left in the quarter. Here's Montag across half court for Garrigan. Gets it over to the right towards Hoagland, now down to Capacious. Works the baseline, kicks it out to Bartolo. Pass got tipped on the way out, but Bartolo collected it. Now Montag, top of the key. Montag slicing in. Montag puts it up, and she drew the foul. That's a lot of ball, but a little bit of hand. And Zoe Montag continues to attack. She's not just someone who will sit out and only shoot three-pointers anymore. She is really taking initiative the past couple of weeks to attack off the dribble, try to get past the defenders that close out too hard and see if she can find an open lane to the basket or draw a foul. She just did. First free throw rims out, and the score stays 44-36. Well, the back-to-back defending state champions getting all they can handle on the road tonight in Buffalo Center. 44-36 is Montag's second free throw. That one a little bit short, but it rattles up and in. The friendly rubber rim for Zoe Montag, and Bishop Garrigan stretching it out to a 9-point lead. It got down as low as 6 as Montag goes to the bench. Right now it's Hoagland, Kemna, Capacious, Murphy, and Bartolo for Bishop Garrigan. Gray drives right side for North Iowa, and Gray double dribbled. Turnover for the Bison, and now a chance for Bishop Garrigan to get back into a double-digit lead right before the end of the third quarter. The offensive players will check back in with Aulish and Montag and Eastman all coming in. Bishop Garrigan can pretty much work this all the way down. 1 second difference between game clock and shot clock. 32 seconds left on the game clock as Bartolo brings it across half court. Bishop Garrigan has had a long, long stretch of dominance against North Iowa, including a 71-41 win earlier this season. But North Iowa trying to change that tonight here inside of their home gymnasium. 17 seconds left in the quarter. Eastman pivots around on the foul line, gets it out to Montag. Free from the right side. Too strong. Rebound Capacious, though. 11 seconds left. Capacious out towards Aulish. Aulish right side free, and Aulish swishes it. Sasha Aulish extending that Garrigan lead. Now 2 seconds in the quarter. 1 second. Half court heave on the way. Hoffman rims out, no good. That is the end of the third quarter as Garrigan does get a little late push. They score the last 6 points of the third and lead 48-36 heading into the fourth on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
Farmer State Bank is proud to be part of our community. Offices in Algona, Whittemore, and West Bend.
Stroman Dental, giving you something to smile about.
Bill's Auto and Truck Repair. Service is the difference.
Trend Salon, your complete family hair salon. It's all about you.
Oakcrest Funeral Services, celebrating a life lived.
Algona Frame and Auto Body, we meet by accident.
Water Connection, from softeners to bottled water and service, call 295-SOFT.
Algona Pizza Ranch, there's so much to love.
Cotton Grave Farm Management and Land Realty in downtown Algona. Trusted for farmland service needs since 1960.
Sponsoring this broadcast on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Iowa Bison hanging tough against the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. Bishop Garrigan up 48-36 going into the fourth quarter as the Golden Bears have the rock right now. After all that work for North Iowa to get back into the game, ultimately they only outscored Garrigan by one in that third quarter, 14-13, and that's because Bishop Garrigan ended the quarter on a 6-0 scoring run. Bison did have the game down to 6 at one point as Eastman has it in the high post, gets it right side to Montag in the corner. Out to the top towards Bartolo, 13 on the shot clock. High post again to Eastman, driving in. Eastman, layup up and in! 50-36, Bishop Garrigan as Eastman sets the tone to start the fourth quarter. She now has 12 points. Bison go the other way, needing a bucket. Binken top of the key. Garrigan going to stay back in a 2-3 zone right now. Binken gets to the foul line, hoists up the shot. It's no good. Ball pinballs out. Rebound by Langfold for North Iowa, and she'll bring it back outside with 7:15 on the clock. Pass to Beekler, top of the key. Aulish flies by. Bartolo flies by. Extra pass left side. Hoffman, her free point ball misses off to the left, and Montag tracks down the rebound. Hoffman just struggling on three-point shots, about 12% from the three-point line so far this season. Right now, the leading scorer for Garrigan, Aulish with 18 points. Montag has 11. Capacious along the baseline, gets it out to Montag, top of the key. Extra pass, Bartolo, right side Trey, in and out, no good. Sailing in for the rebound is Binken for North Iowa. She's the number four rebounder in the top of Iowa West this year, and she has the ball across half court right now, 6:42 left in the fourth quarter. Golden Bears will win tonight. They clinch the outright conference title. If they lose tonight, it opens it up for Forest City to tie Bishop Garrigan as Montag steals the pass away. Montag up to Bartolo, in transition, layup up and in. The defense turning into offense for Bishop Garrigan. It's 52-36 as the Golden Bears grab the first 4 points of the fourth quarter. Bison came in 8th place out of the 9 teams in the top of Iowa West, 4-11 in the conference, but an improved team down the stretch as a 3-point ball by Hoffman is left short, and Capacious flags it on the rebound near the right side baseline. Bishop Garrigan senior bringing the ball across half court right now. Finds Aulish, and she'll head right around the perimeter. 18 points by Stacia Aulish, trying for another 20-point game tonight after a couple early in the season. Eastman to the baseline, Capacious. Kicks it out to Aulish. Aulish left angle three-pointer, and she hit it again! Stacia Aulish having a big night. 21 points for the Bishop Garrigan sophomore, and the Golden Bears stretching out that lead. A 7-0 scoring run to start the fourth quarter, and it's 55-36. Those three balls are gradually starting to drop again, ladies and gents. Beekler, mid-range J from the left side, knocks it down. That'll quiet the Garrigan momentum for a moment. 16 points by Beekler tonight. She's having a tremendous game. Aulish feeling it. Heat check three is short. Rebound Capacious. Under the bucket, Capacious finds the cutting Eastman. Got knocked back into the hands of Capacious, and she'll get it out to Montag. Montag drives in, finds Capacious deep in the post. Layup up, and it bounces in for Eastman. The Golden Bears continue to score on every possession so far in the fourth quarter. 14 points by Eastman, 57-38 Golden Bears, and this thing is stretching out to a 19-point lead in the blink of an eye. And Capacious steals the pass along the baseline. Another turnover by the Bison, who are now starting to press here in the fourth. Montag heads left. Montag kicks it out towards Aulish. Aulish drives across the lane, jumps and passes towards Eastman. Ball got poked away by the Bison, but the Golden Bears get it out. Aulish pump fakes Job. Aulish drives in. Aulish takes it all the way inside. The swap by Eastman. The swap by Binkin, that is, as the rebound is taken by Capacious. 4:41 left in the fourth quarter. Bartolo over towards Montag. Montag slicing in. Oh, the great sidestep and the score! What a move as she put Binkin in the blender that time. Montag faked to the right, went left, and Binkin was totally lost in the paint. What a great play by Zoe Montag. 59-38 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. The Golden Bears continuing a big run to start the fourth, and North Iowa is going to take a timeout. We'll take the timeout as well right here on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube stream.
At Security State Bank, we focus on the needs of local families, businesses, and farmers. Decisions are made locally. We live and work in your neighborhood, helping to keep our local community vibrant and growing. We're involved in local community events. We believe in personalized service and advice that meets or exceeds your expectations. We're Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne. Bankers who believe in you. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender. Security State
Bank. For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
An 11-2 scoring run to start the fourth quarter by the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, pulling away from the North Iowa Bison right now, 59-38. Meanwhile, across town, Algona beat a tough Pocahontas area team tonight on the road, 64-59, so a good win by the Bulldog girls tonight. Bishop Garrigan's girls are trying to clinch a conference title in tonight's ball game, as they'll do it outright if a win. 4:14 left in the fourth quarter. Left wing three-point ball. Beekler, no good. Job had the rebound briefly. Aulish knocked it away. Capacious saves it into Aulish. And here comes Aulish weaving up into the front court. She avoids the referee along the near side. Aulish flings it across towards Bartolo. Catch and fire free. And a swish! Emmy Bartolo hits the free. And Garrigan cannot miss here in the fourth quarter. 10 points by Bartolo tonight. 62-38. If you're just tuning in now and looked at the score, you would not realize how close this game was. A very, very short time ago, the Bison had cut Garrigan's lead down to 6 points during the third quarter, but since that time, a massive run by the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. 6-0 to end the third quarter, and now 14-2 to start the fourth. Pass down to the baseline, shoveled back in by the Bison, but they throw it right to Bartolo. Eichenberger couldn't save it. Here comes Bartolo striding up, finding Montag. She'll wait and hold it. Out top to Bartolo. Foul into Eastman, down to the baseline, Capacious. Capacious reverse, no good on the layup. Ball is loose, Capacious got her own miss. Kicks out to Aulish, but threw it out of bounds to the Golden Bear bench. And Job took a hit that time for North Iowa, as she'll be a little slower getting up, but does appear to be okay. She'll climb to her feet. But the activity by Abby Capacious, unmatched. That is a high motor player for Garrigan, getting even her own misses
as she has 4 points tonight, but countless rebounds for the Golden Bears. Golden Bears have four starters in double figure scoring as the ball gets knocked out of bounds. Bison will keep it though. Last touch by Bishop Garrigan. Bison with just one starter in double figures. That's Beekler of 16. Last time these teams matched up, North Iowa had three double-digit scores with Langfald scoring 17, Binken with 10, and Eichenberger of 10. As we said, Beekler of 16 so far tonight, the only double-digit score for the Bison. She has the ball right now, steps into a left-wing three-pointer. It's off the heel, no good. Ball's high in the air on the rebound, and Eastman reaches above everyone and secures it. Bartola outlets to Allish, but Beekler intercepts it. Here comes Beekler running the floor all by herself. Layup up and in. The big night for Ashlyn Beekler. Now sees her of 18 points as Garrigan leads 62-40. Golden Bears looking for their second top of Iowa West win in a row after beating West Hancock 57-38 on Friday night. Allish left side to Eastman. Eastman driving her way in, right side. She got blocked, but a foul of 2:28 left. Eastman's going to shoot. And if that's on Binken, that'll be her fourth. No, that'll actually end up being on Eichenberger for North Iowa, her first. Believe it or not, that was the first foul by either team so far in the fourth quarter. Quarter four flowing smoothly so far on both sides. As the free ball, or the free throw, that is up and good by Eastman, giving her 15 points tonight and giving Garrigan a 63-40 advantage. North Iowa made things tough tonight for Eastman as she routed the free throw in. Tough to get her the pass down low in the first half, but Garrigan made the adjustment. They've been putting Eastman a lot in the high post in the second half, and she's had to work a little bit off the dribble. She's had to drive in herself rather than just catching that entry pass in the low post. But she's showing a diversity of offensive talent so far in tonight's game, as it's a 24-point lead by Bishop Garrigan. Binken, 15-footer, rattles into the cup. That'll be the first field goal by Miriam Binken so far tonight. And she now has 3 points as it's a 64-42 Garrigan advantage with 2:07 left in the ballgame. Capacious out towards Montag, right side. Montag heads left and flings it over towards Bartolo. Now left corner towards Allish. 20 seconds left on the shot clock. She'll get it back out towards Bartolo. Just kept it inside of half court. Bounce pass towards Montag on the right wing. Montag sidearms it towards the lane. Knock away by Beekler. And Beekler will be fouled in transition with 1:49 left. Golden Bears will bring Hoagland back into the ballgame as Sasha Allish picks up her fourth foul. Hoagland and Kemna checking in as Allish and Capacious go to the pine. If that is it for Sasha Allish, she's going to finish with 21 points tonight, if that is indeed her final action. 1:49 left, and Bishop Garrigan removing all doubts, up 64-42. Price passing it over to the left side towards Gray. As it'll be Price working the ball right now, flinging it near side to Beekler. Beekler feeling it again for three, left it short. And the rebound on the near side, controlled briefly by Murphy, trying to rip it away from traffic. And a foul. Oh, man, and Beekler ended up flinging Murphy to the ground. Whether that was intentional or not, that was after the whistle there. She was scrapping for the basketball of Regan Murphy. And that is a physical battle going on as Beekler picks up her fourth foul. I'll tell you what, anytime you are grappling with Murphy for a rebound, it is going to go all the way down to the whistle on both sides as North Iowa brings Lisa Heyer into the ballgame. Price will go to the bench with 1:31 left in this one. Garrigan will bring Elena Casey in for the first time tonight. Was able to score her first point of the season on Friday night against West Hancock in that Golden Bear victory over the Eagles. So right now, Kemna, Bartolo, Hoagland, Casey, and Murphy for Bishop Garrigan. With 1:23 left in this one and a 64-42 Bishop Garrigan advantage, Casey high post, lobs it near side to Kemna. Gets it out to the top to Bartolo. Kemna looking in towards Casey, now up to Bartolo. Bartolo out to the right towards Hoagland. 14 on the shot clock, back out to Bartolo. Left side to Kemna, spins away from the jumping Gray, who tried to get that pass. Now Bartolo, a deep right side freeze, an air ball, heading out of bounds. Murphy trying to save it, but it'll hit that royal blue base padding along the baseline as Garrigan will turn it over. Bartolo checks out. Ava Roffler will check in for the Golden Bears of 1:01 left. Well, Bishop Garrigan will get exactly what the doctor ordered now. A long week-plus chance to just rest, practice, and hit the gym and really work on things before the playoffs roll around, as Coach Schwab talked about the need for a little more practice. That'll be a foul by Reese Kemna trying to rip the ball out of Potter's hands for North Iowa. But Coach Schwab really feels the Golden Bears can clean up a few things. They just get a couple good practices in a row, but between the sickness by Eastman and some of the other players on the team last week, and between the games bunched together with the game on Friday and now the game here on Monday night. There just has not been a lot of practice time for Bishop Garrigan to work with. So before the playoffs, there's going to be a lot of practice time. That's going to be very much welcome for the Golden Bears as they head into the playoffs and get ready for what will hopefully be another deep run. 45 seconds left in the fourth quarter. Roffler on the right wing. Roffler working the dribble, bouncing it up towards Hoagland. Now Kemna left side with 38 seconds left. 64-42, Bishop Garrigan. Murphy short corner gets it into Casey. Casey kicks it out to Kemna. Golden Bears rotated around to Hoagland, feeling it for three, and Hoagland banks it in. That is the exclamation point as Hoagland hits it off the window for three. 67-42, Bishop Garrigan, as we're down to the final 20 seconds of this game. North Iowa with one more offensive possession. It's down towards the baseline as Eichenberger trying to secure it with 12 seconds. Bounce pass knocked out of bounds by Murphy, and it will stay with North Iowa. Well, it's going to be the same story for Bishop Garrigan, but a different way to get there. Five conference titles in a row by the Golden Bears, and the pass is caught. Eichenberger's shot is partially blocked. It's in the lane, and that'll be a foul with 7.2 seconds left. Of course, the old story was Audie Crooks, Molly Joyce, two of the great players in the state of Iowa and two of the greatest players in the history of Garrigan basketball. They both graduated and the questions persisted. Can Bishop Garrigan still do it without those two? 6 seconds left. North Iowa has the ball. Eichenberger gets it to the foul line for a jumper by Gray. It misses off to the right. That's no good. Final seconds ticking away and put it in the books. The top of Iowa's title is Bishop Garrigan's and Bishop Garrigan's alone. The Golden Bears do it for the fifth season in a row. No Joyce, no Crooks, but this team created their own identity and won the conference. Golden Bears win their 20th game and wrap the regular season 20-2. They are 15-1 in top of Iowa West play, and they go into the playoffs having defeated North Iowa 67-42 in tonight's ball game. A lot of teams fought Garrigan to be down. A lot of teams doubted what the Golden Bears had coming back, but they fought about what Garrigan lost rather than what they had returning. And what Garrigan had returning is a conference title caliber team, a team ranked in the top 10 of Class 1A, and a team that just secured an outright conference title tonight in Buffalo Center, Iowa. 67-42 is the final score. We'll step aside for a timeout. Look at the final scoring numbers coming up next on Home Country KLGZ.
We've got more Sports Club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions. Satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op. Delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump It. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters. Growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Up at game number one of our basketball doubleheader here on Home Country Radio, KLGZ Algona, and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream. It is a 67-42 final score as Bishop Garrigan does it again. They do it a bit differently this time. A younger team, no Crooks, no Joyce, but the same result. A conference title on the top of Iowa West, the fifth in a row by Bishop Garrigan. They're going to end the regular season with an excellent 20 wins, a 20-2 record, and a 15-1 mark in conference play. North Iowa wraps the regular season 7-14 overall and 4-12 in the top of Iowa West Conference. They will finish eighth in the top of Iowa West. As we take a look at the final scoring numbers, before we do that, a big thank you once again to our video streaming sponsors on the YouTube channel, Iowa State Bank, where they help people succeed, Kemna Auto Center, where it's not just about the car, it's about the care, PMC Advantage Insurance Services, where having the advantage makes all the difference, Algona Frame and Auto Body, where we meet by accident, Bauer Plumbing and Heating of Emmitsburg and Algona Municipal Utilities, community owned for community benefit. The individual scoring numbers went like this: for Bishop Garrett,
Garrigan, Stacia Allish led the way with 21 points. Graceland Eastman finishes with 16. Zoe Montag had 13. Emmy Bartolo had 10. It was Abby Capacious scoring 4 and Alyssa Hoagland scoring 3, accounting for the 67 points tonight by the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears. For the North Iowa Bison, one score in double digits. That was Ashlyn Beekler scoring 18 points. Aisha Job had 7 in tonight's game. Becca Hoffman had 5. Bella Langfald had 5 as well. Miriam Binken had 3. Alexis Gray had 2 and Brooklyn Price had 2. Again, all those scoring numbers unofficial for tonight's matchup. The scoring by quarter looked like this. In the first quarter, Bishop Garrigan had an 18-8 scoring advantage, and the Golden Bears also had a 17-14 advantage during the second quarter, going up 35-22 heading into halftime. In the third quarter, though, North Iowa made their run. At one point, they cut Bishop Garrigan's lead down to 6 points. Ultimately, the Golden Bears, though, closed the third quarter on a 6-0 run. North Iowa, though, would outscore Bishop Garrigan in the third, 14-13, as the score is 48-36 Golden Bears heading into the fourth. But Bishop Garrigan slammed the door in the final 8 minutes, outscoring North Iowa 19-6 in the fourth quarter. They started the fourth quarter on a 14-2 scoring run, which means between the end of the third quarter and the start of the fourth, Bishop Garrigan outscored North Iowa 20-2, and that was the difference in the ballgame tonight, this 67-42 Golden Bear win. Again, it wasn't always pretty, especially in that third quarter for Bishop Garrigan. North Iowa got hot. Ashlyn Beekler almost single-handedly took over the game during about a 4-minute stretch during that third quarter, but Bishop Garrigan got a little test here tonight. They had to work through a little trouble during that third quarter, and ultimately they responded in the fourth. They closed the door and they get a win. And now they go back to the gym. They get a ton of practice time a week plus before they open up the playoffs on Tuesday night of this upcoming week. So a week from tomorrow, Bishop Garrigan will play either North Iowa in a rematch of tonight's game or West Hancock in a rematch of this past Friday night. So in any case, it'll be a familiar foe to open up the playoffs on Tuesday night of next week for Bishop Garrigan. Like we said, for North Iowa, they start off their playoffs on Thursday night of this week, battling the West Hancock Eagles in their opening playoff matchup, and the winner of that one gets the rematch against the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears and run it back. Bishop Garrigan now 20-2 on the season. That'll end it for the regular season. 15-1 in conference play. North Iowa falls to 7-14, 4-12 in the conference. We'll stick around. We'll have the boys matchup coming up next, as both teams will wind down the regular season in that one as well, and we will replay the interview that Coach Meister did at halftime of the girls game in case you missed that, so we'll get Coach Meister's pregame thoughts for Bishop Garrigan. That'll be coming up after these messages on 98.5 FM, AM 1600 and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Reeves Wicked Good Bar and Grill. For wicked good food, drinks, and service, you gotta go to Reeves.
CB Grain Solutions, satisfaction guaranteed.
New Way K&H Co-op, delivering exceptional value through knowledge and innovation.
Dump it. They do the dirty work so you don't have to.
Albert Electric. Flip the switch to Albert Electric.
Grassmasters, growing satisfied customers.
Greg Penning and Company, certified public accountants, where everyone counts.
Yemlin Builders and Apartments, quality apartments for rent, beauty and craftsmanship that will never go out of style.
Daylight Donuts, open early with delicious donuts and great coffee.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
As we come back here at halftime on Home Country Radio KLGZ, the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears lead the North Iowa Bison 35-22. Right now we're going to check in with boys coach Mark Meister and preview the action coming up in that ball game. Coach, first of all, we appreciate your time here at halftime. Let's first flash back to Friday night as you guys were able to defeat West Hancock 65-30 in that ball game. So, you know, Friday night, obviously a good performance by the team. What are a couple big things that stood out to you?
Our defense collectively as a group, I thought Trayton Sink did a heck of a job on their best player, that Smith kid. We kind of didn't allow him to do as much. We ran a double at him off a few of their shooters that weren't shooting as well, and we were able to execute that really well and held them to 30. We were really happy with that. That was kind of our goal was, you know, can we hold them 10 under their scoring? And, well, we ended up doing better than that, so it worked out well for us.
Well, Coach, a big trend recently for Bishop Garrigan has been holding opposing teams under their season averages and having some really solid defensive performances start to pile up. So how have you seen things come together on the defensive side as far as just what you feel is driving that improvement as the year goes on?
I think we've gotten cleaner with what we're doing and the rotational things we're trying to do. And certain guys out there, I think some of the chemistry has kind of started to gel with a few of the guys and different rotations we're running now. Some of the groups that we're subbing are doing a better job when they're coming in, understanding what we're supposed to do. We used to get, you know, kind of lost in some of the minutes, and guys come in and they're not sure. You know, it only takes one guy with some of the defenses we try to run to kind of mess it up. So chemistry has really picked up on that end of the floor, and I think maybe a little bit more sense of pride and, you know, meaningfulness moving forward, that, you know, when winning tournaments games is going to take getting stops and getting out and running.
And, Coach, of course, the team's adjusted their lineup as time's gone on. I know, you know, in a couple of the recent games, you've had two bigs in the starting lineup with Nemers and Lear. What do you feel that, I guess, dimension of the lineup has brought to you guys?
Well, I thought they've been playing really well and really well together. Lear's been, you know, kind of on a tear the last five games. He's almost averaging a double-double. So we saw, you know, he needed some more time on the floor with the rebounding and the scoring. He gets a lot of extra possessions for us. I mean, a tip, a steal, he's been doing a lot of that stuff. And then it's kind of freed it up more for Nimmers, even though we still don't think we get him the ball enough. But, you know, Lear's commanding a lot of attention on that side of the paint if he's on opposite blocks. So Logan's been able to do some more things on his side operating. So they've been tough, both of them equally, I've felt.
Well, Coach, you go into tonight's matchup against North Iowa, wrapping up the regular season and seeing the Bison for the second time. What are a couple of things that jump out to you when you look at North Iowa?
Well, they got one of their better players back, so they're a different team right now than what they were the first time we played them. They played Eagle Grove here pretty tough. That was tight for quite a while, and then they kind of lost it as Eagle Grove cranked up the defensive side of it and kind of trapping and pressing. So those are kind of some of the things we're going to try and do to make them handle the ball and make decisions. So hopefully we can execute that.
Coach, along those same lines, what do you feel the biggest key for Bishop Garrigan is tonight?
Well, kind of that, and then getting out and not getting ahead of ourselves on the break. You know, we've got some guys that are doing some really nice things defensively, and they're getting out, and we're telling them to take those layups and, you know, not settle for bad shots. So if I think we do that, it should be a good game for us.
You know, Coach, as we wind down here, obviously the Boys High School Athletic Association released their district assignments today. I guess, did you get a chance to look at that, and what was your reaction to seeing where your team was assigned?
I did. I was pretty happy. You know, obviously I would have preferred maybe the North Union on our side, not the Lake Mills, but we wanted the two seed. We felt we had played well enough. You know, we had given a few games away late, so we were a little concerned if we were going to slide down a little bit, but happy with the two seed, you know, get a couple home games and hopefully some winnable games for us. So I feel pretty good about it overall.
Well, Coach, we appreciate your time today and wish you best of luck with tonight's game.
All right, thanks for having me.
All right, that was Coach Meister of his halftime thoughts at the half of the girls' game. In case you missed that interview, we just replayed it. So Coach Meister previewing tonight's matchup, a 12-9 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears taking on the 2-17 North Iowa Bison in the regular season finale. Right now, we have about 5 minutes to go until tip-off of our Game 2 of the boys' basketball doubleheader. So with that, we'll step aside for a few more messages, get you that boys' basketball action coming up on Home Country Radio and at the Algona Radio YouTube live stream.
At Security State Bank, we realize each customer has a unique set of needs and goals. That's why we place a greater value on providing outstanding customer service. All products and services are designed for customers within our local community. We value each customer that walks through our door and wants to give them the personalized attention they deserve. Find out why Security State Bank in Algona, Burt, and Laverne is your partner in community banking. Member FDIC, Equal Housing Lender.
Security State Bank.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen, when you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of 9 physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone Joint and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Ends tonight. The regular season wraps up for the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears as they visit the North Iowa Bison. The 12-9 Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears come in at 8-7 in conference play. North Iowa 2-17 on the season, 1-14 in the top of Iowa West. It's a boys basketball battle here in Buffalo Center as Bishop Garrigan looks to build on that big time win Friday night at West Hancock. It was a dominating lockdown defensive performance for the Golden Bears in that 65-30 victory. And not only did they see West Hancock in that game, but they're going to see West Hancock in the first round of the playoffs 1 week from tonight. So this will be one final tune for the Golden Bears against a Bison team that, although they lost to Bishop Garrigan the first time around, they played very tough in the first half before the Golden Bears opened it up with a big second half scoring advantage, 40-16. Bishop Garrigan actually led by only one at halftime, and then it was that 40-16 scoring advantage in the second half to blow things open. One thing the Bison will have in this game that they did not have in that first matchup is Jeffrey Gerber. Gerber, a 10.7 point per game scorer, an experienced senior in that starting lineup, is going to try to narrow the gap between the Golden Bears and the Bison as North Iowa will try to get this regular season upset on their home court to end the regular season. We'll step aside for one final timeout. Tip off of the game next. The Golden Bears and the Bison on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, Home Country Radio.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC. For over 40 years, Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons have maintained one mission: to provide excellence in orthopedic care. Their team of nine physicians offer specialized care in everything from arthroscopic same-day surgery to joint replacement, as well as hand and foot surgery, and have an orthopedic surgeon on call 24/7. Healthcare isn't about appointments, it's about taking care of people, and that's their specialty. Visit Northwest Iowa Bone, Joint, and Sports Surgeons on the web at nwiabone.com.
And And we get the broadcast rolling right now on Home Country Radio KLGZ. Some confusion for the starting lineup tonight. Drew Mahler came out for the Golden Bears, but the PA announcer announced Nick Lear. So the Golden Bears are going to have to change their plans. They wanted Drew Mahler starting, but instead it's going to be Lear, Nemers, Joyce, Schwab, and Sink. So it was supposed to be Lear, or it was supposed to be Mahler that is in the lineup instead of Lear, but the Golden Bears will have to adjust because I guess the scoring table got out of the wrong lineup, or Garrigan was just confused as to who should start. But in any case, they'll adjust from that. North Iowa, they're going to have Brendan Price, Brogan Greensky, Jeffrey Gerber, Jackson Potter, and Jameson Kramersmeyer as the Golden Bears win the opening tap. Joyce almost got tripped up, and we are underway here in North Iowa's high school gymnasium. Sink on the right wing for the Golden Bears, gets it inside to Nemers. Bobbles it though, and it's taken away by Gerber for North Iowa. Bison head right to left on the radio dial. They get it out to Price. Early 3-point try, and Price cans it. Good start for North Iowa as Brendan Price, the junior, knocks down a 3-point ball. He's a 24.4% 3-point shooter this year. And he's taken 150, or he's made 156 threes this year coming into tonight. Joyce near the top of the key, gets it right side to Schwab. 30 seconds gone here, quarter number one. Schwab and a double team and a jump ball. Bison coming out with an aggressive trap in defense. That time it was Potter, as well as Gerber, trapping Schwab there as he couldn't pivot away from the traffic of the Bison. So they're going to play aggressive defensively against the Golden Bears and try to really pressure the guards into some mistakes, it appears. 3-0 North Iowa. Bison scoring 47.1 points per game this year. Garrigan allowing 56.5 points. As the pass goes left corner for the Bison, it's Greensky, the senior, averaging 9.4 points per game. Brings it out as he bounces it to Kramersmeyer. Kramersmeyer left around the perimeter. We've got a whistle and a 3-second call going against North Iowa. I believe that was Gerber who they saw camping out in the lane for the Bison as the turnover will go against North Iowa. Golden Bears number four in the conference in offense. They've scored 61.6 points per game so far. Bison allowing 66.3, so they're looking to see an improved defensive effort tonight against the Golden Bears. Schwab on the right side gets the top of the key to Joyce. Joyce gets to the foul line and our hands to Schwab. Now down to the short right corner to Nemers. Out to Joyce. Joyce, a wing 3-point try. A little bit too strong. Rebound is tipped around off the hands of Lear and tracked down by Greensky for the Bison. Greensky brings it across the timeline as he heads towards the right side. A between-the-legs dribble against Joyce as Greensky will back it up in between the circles at the 6:37 mark of quarter number one. Kramersmeyer on the wing dribbles towards the center of the court, guarded by Nemers. Fakes left, fires the pass, and it's intercepted by Lear. He was looking over towards Jackson Potter on the left side, but an errant pass will be a turnover by North Iowa. Bison turning it over 16 times per game this season as Garrigan forces the early turnover. Nemers in the high post gets it out towards Joyce, just left the center. Joyce, the leading scorer at 14 points per game for Bishop Garrigan this season. And now Schwab drives, slicing in, got to the rack and scored, and a foul. Chance for a 3-point play by Carter Schwab. Once again, that's that strong drive by the Bishop Garrigan sophomore. He is unstoppable when he gets going and gets the momentum behind him. As Schwab, a 54% foul shooter, will try to tie the game at three. 6:09 left in quarter number one. Schwab, three throw, bounces into the cup, and we are locked up at three apiece. North Iowa hit an early three ball. Schwab got a three the old-fashioned way, and the Bison come back the other direction. The two wins so far this season for North Iowa, 59-47 over Rockford back on December 5th, and 63-53 over Belmont Clemmie on December 15th, so they have not won in 2024 as Kramersmeyer is blocked by Nemers, and Sink collects the loose basketball. Nemers, that rim protection for Bishop Garrigan, and now here come the Golden Bears heading left to right on the radio dial. Schwab across half court, hands the ball off to Joyce, heading towards the near side, bounce pass towards Nemers' right elbow. Nemers back outside to Joyce. Joyce wants to drive. Offensive foul against Bishop Garrigan. This will be the first foul against the Golden Bears, as that one is picked up by Nick Lear away from the play. So one foul by each side so far in this one. Bison looking to snap a 12-game losing streak tonight and do it here inside of their home gymnasium. North Iowa is set to battle West Bend Mallard this Friday night in the preliminary round. Winner of that game gets the privilege of facing Lake Mills in the traditional first round of the playoffs next week. Ball's on the left wing towards Greensky. Top of the key, it's a free ball. Potter, and he cans it! Couple three-point balls by North Iowa to start the ball game, and it's 6-3 Bison. Potter came into today 1 of 19 on free balls, so that's his second trifecta of the season. And the Bison lead Bishop Garrigan early 6-3. Nemers down below the sink, makes a tough catch, lays it up and in! 6-5 right now is Trayton Sink. Continues the trend of the recent couple games. Scored 9 points against Forest City, then ended up scoring 10 against West Hancock. There's a hard drive by Greensky. Used the off-arm, though, and that's an offensive foul. That was a clear call for the officials. Greensky picks up his first personal foul. That left arm shot way out into the open where everyone could see it, as that'll be a foul on Greensky, and Garrigan gets the ball back. Bishop Garrigan graduating four of the top five scorers from last season, but
still finding a way to score 61-plus points a game this year as Joyce has the ball between the circles. Gets the screen by Lear. Joyce driving right side. Joyce taking it in. Got all the way to the cup, and he bounced in the layup. First lead by Bishop Garrigan. It's 7-6 as Michael Joyce has his first two on the board of the night. Mahler gets ready to check in at the next stoppage for the Golden Bears as he awaits by the scoring table. Left side, it's Price, the junior for North Iowa, holding the rock. Gets the Kramers-Meyer screen. Sidesteps into a hard-arcing free, and he arcs it up and in. Second free ball by Brendan Price, and North Iowa shooting from the perimeter. It's 9-7 Bison. Our second early lead change of this ball game. Joyce between the circles, awaits the screen by Nemers. Green Sky stays in front of Joyce. Now Schwab, top of the key, looks inside and underhands it out to Joyce. Joyce flings it over to Sink, looks into the post to Lear. Lear hooks up a tough shot, bounces off the rim, no good, and a contested rebound taken by Gerber for North Iowa. Gets it up ahead to Potter. Potter driving in. Potter along the baseline, kicks it back out into the right corner to Green Sky, rotates it around, wide open free Gerber, and Gerber rattles it in! The Bison are hot early, and they're up 12-7. All 12 points coming by way of the free ball. Gerber's the guy you've really got to watch. A 35% three-point shooter so far this year for North Iowa. Missed the first game between these two due to injury. Sink, 16-foot jumper. Off the heel, no good. Rebound by Lear and kick out to Schwab. Schwab, three-point try. Rims out, no good. Nemers taps the rebound away. That's collected by Potter along the right side baseline for North Iowa. Potter, the 6'1 junior, gets it into the front court as he'll find Gerber on the wing. Now back to Potter, edge of the paint. Works against Lear, underhands it to Green Sky. Green Sky was out of bounds. That's a pass that you can't make if you're Potter. Green Sky was working his way around a couple of black jerseys, but he was clearly standing out of bounds when Potter released that basketball, and he said, I don't want that ball, but it was coming his way, and that is going to be a turnover by the Bison. Justin Bauer enters the ballgame for the first time tonight for Bishop Garrigan, the 6-foot senior, as Nemers and Sink heads the bench. The other substitution will be Amari Thomas, as Thomas, the 6'3 sophomore for Garrigan, will be the center. 3:12 left in quarter number one. Joyce across half court. Bounce pass towards Thomas, right wing. Thomas back out to Joyce, setting a screen. Thomas rolls the pass to Thomas. Thomas under the bucket. Thomas layup, swirls into the cup. Nice pick and roll executed by the Golden Bears as Amari Thomas has his first two of the evening. 12-9, North Iowa leading Bishop Garrigan as walking a ball across half court is Brogan Greensky. He'll hand it off to Potter. Potter turns his back and flings it out towards Gerber, guarded by Mahler. Gerber to the foul line. Mahler staying in front. Kicks it over to the right through Green Sky. Rises for a three, and Green Sky hits it! Are you kidding me? What a start by the Bison. 5 3-point makes in the first quarter and a 15-9 lead. North Iowa is just a 25.5% three-point shooting team this year. Schwab tries to answer, and he rattles a three into the cup. Carter Schwab with a friendly rubber rim. It rattled around, and it dropped through. That is 6 early points by the Bishop Garrigan sophomore. 15-12 the score right now. Inside Gerber, shoots over Thomas and scores. That is a new dimension to the North Iowa offense. A 2-point make. 5 points by Gerber. Schwab the other way. Looking out to Joyce, he'll get it right to Mahler. Mahler will try 3. They dared him to shoot it. Off the back of the cup, no good. And the long rebound deflects out to the foul line to Kramersmeyer. Gerber into the front court. The flowing hair bangs the way into Mahler. Offensive foul again. Second offensive foul by North Iowa. First one by Green Sky. That one by Gerber. And that time just buried the shoulder into the chest of Drew Mahler. That'll be foul number 3 against North Iowa as Schwab will head to the bench. Nemers comes in for Bishop Garrigan. Bison will go to the bench for the first time tonight as North Iowa has 1:55 left on the clock here in quarter number one. Carter Copen, the 6-foot freshman coming off the pine for North Iowa. 1:49 left here in quarter number one, a 17-12 Bishop Garrigan lead. Bauer looking and passing to Mahler right side. Mahler looking to Nemers, center of the paint. Deals towards Bauer right corner. Top of the key to Joyce. Joyce driving right of the lane. Joyce got to the rack. He scored it. He drew the foul. Chance for a 3-point play by Michael Joyce. Again, that beautiful footwork by the Bishop Garrigan freshman. Tiptoeing his way right of the lane. Staying strong through the contact. And just great English off the glass. Seems like no matter where Joyce hits it off the window, he can find a way to spin it into the cup. 17-14, North Iowa. Joyce's free throw is on the way, and he swishes it. 2-point lead by the Bison, 17-15. Joyce with an early 5 for Bishop Garrigan, as we're down to 1.5 minutes left in quarter number one. Green Sky crossed half court. Deep three-pointer by Price, and Price left that one short as it tickled the net. Mahler brings it up ahead for Garrigan. Last time these teams matched up, North Iowa did lead by 1 at the end of the first quarter, so they've had a way to start hard against Garrigan. Joyce mid-range, Jay from the right side knocks it down. We are tied at 17. Nothing but net by Michael Joyce. The versatile offense adding the mid-range game here early on in this ball game. 1 minute left in the first quarter. Green Sky working off the dribble. Green Sky, tough shot over Mahler. Can't spin it in off the window. Rebound by Joyce. Joyce on the push. A behind-the-back dribble as he drifts towards the far side of the court. Joyce trying to shake loose from Green Sky. Joyce driving in. Shoots over Kramersmeyer. Banks it off to the right. No good. Nemers clean up. His putback is no good. And Green Sky secures the rebound along the left baseline. Green Sky near the script Bison at midcourt with 40 seconds left in the first quarter. Green Sky on the right wing, dribbles between the legs. Green Sky sidesteps, but doesn't take the three. He'll give it off to Kramersmeyer. Kramersmeyer gets it over to the left. Now 29 seconds left in the first quarter. Pass goes right side towards Green Sky again. 13 seconds left on the shot clock. Green Sky top of the key against Bauer. Green Sky shovels the pass into the corners. He finds Price. Price of 7 on the shot clock. Drives into the lane. Tough 15-footer. Off the back of the cup, no good. As that's a foul on the rebound. Bauer got run into that time by Price. That'll be the first foul on Price. Boy, that's a tough shot, though, by Green Sky. His momentum is taking him left as he's at the foul line trying to square up for that shot. And that is actually foul number 5 already by North Iowa. So Garrigan is going to trek back down and shoot free throws. Justin Bauer just under 53% from the line so far this season. As he'll shoot 2 and try to give Bishop Garrigan a lead. First free throw off the heel, no good. And we stay tied at 17. Kevin Hagen checking in for North Iowa, as well as Jeffrey Gerber, the coming back in. As 14.3 seconds remain in the first quarter, so North Iowa does have plenty of time to get the ball back down the floor and try to find a way to score here. Second free throw goes down the drain for Bauer. That's the third lead change in this ball game so far. The first point by Justin Bauer, as right now it's Garrigan 18, North Iowa 17. There's the drive on the other end by North Iowa, and it's going to be a foul whistled against Garrigan. Third foul on the Golden Bears, and the only question here is going to be, was that in the act of shooting or was that foul not? They're going to say not in the act of shooting, a blocking foul called against Bishop Garrigan. Bison will inbound the ball. They'll get it in towards Potter. His shot is blocked. Nemers got a hand on it. Golden Bears at 3 seconds. Nemers gets it out the sink from just inside half court. Sink rises and bangs the shot off the window to the right. No good. But the Golden Bears inch ahead at the end of the first quarter. It's Bishop Garrigan 18 and North Iowa 17 as we hit the end of the first quarter on KLGZ 98.5 FM and AM 1600.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Algona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, 2 sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Algona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle, passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Algona and Armstrong, keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Algona tree service.
Sports club members bringing you this game.
Three-point makes in the first quarter by the North Iowa Bison, but Bishop Garrigan inches ahead 18-17 as we enter the second quarter. Golden Bears will have the rock heading left to right on the radio dial. Tyler Lance riding solo tonight as Bishop Garrigan has the basketball right now. Joyce top of the key. He'll fling it over to left to Schwab. Beanie Bodie is busy tonight, folks, and we do have an explanation as Schwab drives in and he draws the foul. Beanie is actually taking a seabound vessel down to the ruins of the Titanic to explore that, so we wish Beanie the best of safety in that trip. As he is down exploring the ruins of the Titanic, taking that submarine, that seabound vessel down there. Beanie is always the explorative type, so he could not make it tonight's basketball game. Joyce passes into Nemers. Oh, a nice touch pass towards Lear. Lear layup good, and the foul. Nemers made that play, though, just tips that pass to Lear on the opposite side block, and Lear had the perfect angle for the two. Chance for a three-point opportunity by the Bishop Garrigan Jr., who, as Coach Meister talked about, he has been playing tremendous basketball the past couple of weeks, nearly averaging a double-double, and he knocks down the free throw. Largest lead for Garrigan so far, 21-17. Now can the Bison find a little offense? 15 out of the 17 Bison points so far have come by way of the three-point ball. They did have 1-2 during that first quarter. Green Sky Gets it out towards the right to Price. Bounce pass into the lane. Gerber bangs the way in against Sink. He put it down and the foul. Chance for a 3-point play by Jeffrey Gerber. And there's a 2 for the Bison. Just barreling his way inside. Gerber at 6 feet tall. Just backed his way down against Sink. Took him all the way inside. And that'll be the first foul against Sink. And the first on Bishop Garrigan of this quarter. Gerber of 7 points. And the free throw rims out, no good. That'll be a rebound by Weir. So that'll be the first 2 of the second quarter by North Iowa. And a 2-point Garrigan advantage. Pass is jumped. It's stolen by Gerber. Gerber running the floor, finds the trailing Price. Right back to Gerber. He shoots over Lear, and he draws another foul. Lear finding his vertical, but Gerber thinks he's going to be shooting 2 free throws, and he's right. Gerber, 38.5% from the charity stripe this season. North Iowa taking advantage of that transition opportunity. Golden Bears did defeat the Bison back on December 19th. December 19th, 72-46, the final score in that ball game. Although, as we said, it was a 2-point game at halftime before the Golden Bears outscored the Bison 40-16 as Gerber still cannot connect on that first free throw. 7:09 left here in the second quarter. Gerber of 7 points. Second free throw on the way, and that one goes down the drain. So point there by Gerber, and it's 21-20 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears led by as many as 4. Bounce pass goes towards Lear left side, looking for Joyce. Almost got knocked away. Joyce catches the top of the key. He'll sling the pass towards Schwab in the corner. Works the baseline, shovels it towards Nemers. Kramersmeyer peels it out of the bounds, and he hit it off of Nemers. That is great interior defense by the junior Jameson Kramersmeyer, being asked to match the physicality of Logan Nemers down low as Nemers trying to establish that inside position. And North Iowa has the ball back. 6:46 and ticking here in quarter number 2. Bison averaging just 47 points per game this season, as they've only exceeded 60 points twice. And there's going to be a traveling violation as North Iowa will turn it back over. Nemers will head to the pine. Drew Mahler comes back in for Bishop Garrigan. Mahler, a double-digit rebound in the game against West Hancock as he secured 11 boards. Was also able to score 9 points during that game. A 65-30 Bishop Garrigan win. Really a complete win by Garrigan in that game, but especially great defensive performance. Joyce and DeLear in the post. Back out to Joyce. Quick pass to Schwab. Schwab rises for 3. Missed it right. And the box out by Gerber for the rebound. Such a physical player for North Iowa as Gerber brings it all the way down. He'll kick it into the corner towards Price. The knockaway by Joyce. Here comes Joyce running the floor. He's being pursued by Price. Joyce layup missed. Kramersmeyer taps the ball out, but he tapped it right to Sink. Sink in the lane, and Sink got fouled. North Iowa thought they had dodged a bullet there, but Garrigan had the black jerseys running down the floor in pursuit of that play, and that'll be foul number 2 against Jameson Kramersmeyer for North Iowa, and the third team foul this quarter going against the Bison. Kevin Hagan, the 5'11 freshman, getting set to check in for North Iowa as Trayton Sink makes his way to the foul line. Knocks down the first free throw. Sink, 61.5% from the line this year, as Copen and Hagan both check back in for North Iowa. Both freshmen. Hagan has started 7 games this season for the Bison, but coming off the bench tonight as Garrigan leads 22-20. Sink free throw way short, and the rebound in the lane taken by Copen for the Bison. They outlet it quickly as Hagan has it far side of the court. Down towards Potter. Potter moves back to the bucket, working against Lear. Pivots to face the bucket. He'll pass it towards the left side as the jumper by Copen from the edge of the lane is no good. And Sink keeps the rebound clean for Bishop Garrigan. 5:55 left in the first half. Mahler in the right corner checks his feet to make sure he's in bounds. He is. He pivots and takes 1 dribble. And now North Iowa has him pinned in the corner. And there's a timeout by Bishop Garrigan. Mahler was in trouble there, and Garrigan did not want a 5-second call. 5-second closely guarded call to go against Drew Mahler. So 5:46 on the clock. Bishop Garrigan takes their first timeout of the second half. It'll be a 30-second timeout as we have a good game early on here at North Iowa High School. 22-20 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. And it can certainly be said the Bison, even though they come in at 2-17, a team that's playing a lot better than the record. Jeffrey Gerber, who missed the first game with an injury, is back. Gerber had only played 5 games this season coming into tonight, so he's really just starting to round in midseason form as the Bison are approaching the playoffs. And you can already see watching this game, Gerber really adds some rebounding. He adds some physicality. For a Bison team that likes to take a lot of three-pointers, Gerber's the guy who could really take the ball inside against contact and bigger players. So this Bison team, you can tell they were just not the same without Gerber on the floor earlier in the season. Coming out of the timeout, Golden Bears will have the basketball. Joyce, Schwab, Mahler, Lear, and Sink on the floor right now. Joyce gets the inbounds pass to Schwab, and we are rolling with 5:44 left in the second quarter. It's Mahler right side, bounces it to Joyce, looks left, he'll drive, he'll kick it out to Sink. Rotates it left corner to Schwab with 5:37 left in the first half. Schwab bounce pass to Joyce, top of the key. Joyce working, bounces it into a tight window, and it's intercepted by Gerber. Here comes Gerber. Gerber drives right side and brings it back out as North Iowa doesn't have numbers. And he'll get it out towards Greensky, who makes a fingertip catch. That ball nearly got thrown out of bounds, and now Greensky will bring it back in between the circles and reset the offense for North Iowa. Greensky getting it right to Hagen. Hagen wants to drive. Hagen rising for a jumper, and he left it short. Or that was Copen, I beg your pardon, leaving that one short. And now here comes Schwab. Schwab barreling the other way. Schwab taking it himself. Layup no good. The contest by North Iowa. The rebound by Sink, and Sink got undercut that time on the rebound. North Iowa will pick up the foul, and I believe that's going to be Hagen, the guilty party for the Bison. He'll be picking up his first personal foul. And number four going against North Iowa with 5:01 left in the second quarter. So if you're Garrigan, be physical and be aggressive here. Get that fifth foul inside the Lear. Missed the layup. Got his own miss back. Put back blocked. It's off the window, and North Iowa has the rebound. Greensky outlets it quickly to Copen. Copen runs the floor. Copen got down to the baseline. Copen rises up, and a foul by Bishop Garrigan. Golden Bears get called for the push. That is the third team foul against Bishop Garrigan as Thomas gets set to check in. And that'll be personal foul number two against Drew Mahler. Or check that, number one against Carter Schwab. Got the 23 and 24 backwards. So Copen heading to the foul line where he's over 69% this year, and he'll swish on the first one. 1-point game, 22 to 21 here in Buffalo Center. Well, this North Iowa gym is definitely has a lot of royal blue in it, but definitely has the Bison decor. You probably see if you're watching here on the video stream that great mural in the background. They have three Bison painted on the wall, and really, whoever painted that did a fantastic job as that foul shot is up and good, and the game is tied at 22. I will say, though, I think North Iowa is missing out on an opportunity. Just like the TCU Horned Frogs have the Hypno Toad, I really think North Iowa should have a Hypno Bison to really try to psych out the opposing team. But they went for the normal Bison. The Hypno Bison is maybe a little too risky as Schwab tries a right side three. That one's no good. Rebound by Mahler. Mahler powers it up. He put it in, and the foul. A strong play by Drew Mahler, and a chance for a three-point play. The rebound off the missed three-point shot, and Mahler will try to shoot here to make it a three-point play and a three-point Garrigan lead. Rebounding was a major factor last time these two teams matched up. Bishop Garrigan, as they have often done this season, had a 40-26 rebounding advantage over North Iowa back on December 19th. Mahler free throw off the heel, no good. Sink almost had the rebound, but it deflects over to Gerber, who's getting a ton of rebounds himself for North Iowa. Up to Greensky. Greensky wants to drive. Shoots over Joyce. Tough shot off the top of the window, no good. And Thomas with a contested rebound among the white jerseys. 4:18 left in the second. A two-point lead right now by Bishop Garrigan. Battling it out against North Iowa. Mahler right side. Bounce pass over to Joyce. North Iowa looking for their first win in 2024. Both their wins so far came in 2023 as they get it inside to Thomas, and Thomas able to lay it up and in. Did a really nice job. He got under the bucket, but he leaned all the way back as Thomas has 4 points so far. Golden Bears tried to show a full court press. The Bison break it. Potter runs the other way. Bounce pass to the right side. And putting a shot up and in from the baseline is Copen. 4 points by Copen, 26-24 in favor of Bishop Garrigan. Now Schwab drives in. Schwab powers it up and in, and he drew the foul. Chance for a three-point play by Carter Schwab. Coach Price, not a happy camper on the North Iowa bench, but Schwab with another three-point play opportunity. He has 8 points so far in this ball game. Bison will bring Kramersmeyer back in, who had to spend some time on the bench after picking up his second foul. Gerber will head to the pine for North Iowa as he picked up his third personal. 5 fouls by North Iowa here in the second quarter. This is such an aggressive Bison team. They picked up their fifth foul during the first quarter at about the 5-minute mark, and you do it here just under the 4-minute mark of the second quarter, so they're picking up 5 fouls very quickly and getting Garrigan into the bonus. Schwab converts on the free throw. That's 9 points by the Garrigan sophomore and a 29-24 Garrigan advantage, their largest lead of 5. Copen right in the bucket, layup up. No good as Thomas had the contest, and Thomas has the rebound. Gets the outlet over to Joyce, far side of the court. Joyce left corner to Schwab. Right back to Joyce in the ring. Rise for three. Rattles off, no good. Rebound pinballed out. But that is going to be a foul going against Drew Mahler as he tried to tap the rebound over to Amari Thomas. Second personal foul against Mahler as it comes to the 3:19 mark of the second quarter. Golden Bears will bring in Bauer to replace Sink. North Iowa returns Brendan Price to the ballgame as Hagen goes to the bench. Bison dealing for the Garrigan full court press right now. They'll wing it up ahead to Kramersmeyer and get it across half court. But we've got a whistle and a turnover here by the Bison. I believe it may have been a traveling call there by the Bison as they'll turn it over. So 3:08 left in the first half. Garrigan Right now, their largest lead of the game so far, up by 5 points, trying to extend before halftime of the final 3 minutes. Bauer on the left wing. Bauer bounces it towards Joyce in the corner, looking at the post to Thomas. Right back out to Joyce. Quickly passing it to Schwab. Top of the key three-pointer, and it rattles into the cup! The friendly bounce for Carter Schwab as he hits from downtown, and Garrigan's up 32-24. Schwab shooting 34% on three balls this season, and he has 12 early points for Bishop Garrigan. Green Sky trying to get it up ahead, and this is going to be a 10-second call against the Bison. Golden Bear full-court press, forcing a turnover as the Bison cannot get it across the half-court line before the 10-second mark. And all of a sudden, Garrigan has a chance to get some real momentum before halftime. A bucket here, and you're up by double digits, and then you're feeling really good about yourself if you're Garrigan. This is the Bison team that's lost 12 games in a row and one that battled it out early. They hit 5 three-pointers during the first quarter. But now Garrigan can really put a hurting on the Bison before halftime. Thomas passed to Mahler, out of his reach, but tracked down by Bauer along the perimeter, far side of the court. Schwab gets it right to Joyce, now back to Schwab between the circles. Looks left to Bauer. Bauer into the post to Mahler. Mahler in between two defenders, brings it back out beyond the three-point line. Out to Schwab. Schwab drives in, dumps off to Thomas. Thomas layup, good! What a find by Carter Schwab. And it's 34-24, Bishop Garrigan. Schwab, number 5 in the conference, and assists per game at 4.4, and he picks up a big one right there. Potter gets it out towards Green Sky. Three-point ball in motion. No good as he missed it left. And Mahler secures another board for Bishop Garrigan. Mahler into the front court, gives up to Joyce. North Iowa having a lot of one-and-dones here in the second quarter as Bishop Garrigan leads by 10. Schwab brings it back out. North Iowa playing 2-3 zone right now as Bauer has it on the right wing. Takes one dribble and picks it up, flings it right corner to Mahler. Mahler drives baseline. Ball got stripped away, and Thomas picks it up before it goes out of bounds and kicks it back out to Joyce. 12 on the shot clock. Joyce rising for three, hitting the three-pointer. Michael Joyce from downtown, and Bishop Garrigan has played the Uno reverse card. North Iowa hit all the three-pointers in the first quarter. Garrigan's hitting all these three-pointers in the second quarter, and it's 37-24 just like that. Price left side free, air ball. Rebound, put back, good. Copen is Johnny on the spot that time. He has 6 points off the bench for North Iowa. And it's 37-26. That'll break up the Garrigan run briefly as Joyce splits two defenders, drives in, passes to Mahler in the corner, catch and shoot three, off the front of the cup, no good. Thomas kept that alive briefly, but the rebound got tipped into Kramersmeyer's hands. Alex to Copen. Copen driving in, weaves past Thomas and kicks it out towards Green Sky. Top of the key, Kramersmeyer. Kramersmeyer driving right side, spins left. Kramersmeyer puts up a tough shot, and it looked like he traveled, and he did. A nice defense by Carter Schwab that time as the North Iowa coaching staff and the North Iowa crowd getting very restless right now with 50 seconds left in the second quarter. Well, seemingly about 3 minutes ago, Garrigan led by 2 points. They now lead by 11 and a chance to do more before halftime. 44 seconds on the game clock, 30 on the shot clock. That's a 14-second difference for Bishop Garrigan. As Joyce will have the ball between the circles, gets it right to Schwab. Wide open on the wing. Lets it fly and hits it again. Keep shooting at Carter Schwab. 40-26, Bishop Garrigan, as Schwab has 15 points. 14-point advantage. Bison get it across half court as Potter will wait, and the Bison will bring it back out and work for the last shot. 19 seconds on the game clock. The shot clock is off. All the momentum in the second quarter going to Bishop Garrigan as Schwab runs up to Kramersmeyer. Ball goes right to Price. 10 seconds left. Price with 8 seconds. Price with 7. Gets it over to the right towards Green Sky. Green Sky 4. Green Sky driving. One legger from the foul line, and he drew the foul. 2 free throws coming for broken Green Sky. Took a tough one-legged jumper, but Joyce picks up his first personal foul, and Green Sky will be shooting 2 right before the half. So 2.3 seconds left. Green Sky 55.6% from the charity stripe this season, as he has 3 points so far tonight for North Iowa. And now he has 4. That'll make it 40-27. Well, Gerber has spent a lot of this second quarter on the bench, and that coincides with Garrigan's run. When Gerber left the ballgame, Garrigan heated it up. Second free throw, no good. Rebound by Bauer. Gets it out to Schwab. Three-quarters court heave, and he almost hit that one. Oh, man, Schwab had a three-quarters court heave against Belmont Clemmie early in the season and nearly hit a second one. In any case, Bishop Garrigan will settle for a 13-point lead going into halftime. It's Bishop Garrigan 40 and North Iowa 27 as we hit the half on KLGZ 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Algona Radio YouTube channel.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beich, Jason Brace, Daniel Folt, and Michael Toth.
K
Kemco Tires, they're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency, a fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Time at North Iowa High School as the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears lead the North Iowa Bison 40-27 in this boys basketball matchup. Right now, though, we're going to recap the girls game with Bishop Garrigan senior Abby Capacious. Abby, first of all, congratulations on another conference title, fifth in a row for Bishop Garrigan. Talk to me about what this accomplishment means for you and the team.
You know what? A lot of people kind of doubted us coming into this season, and I am just really proud of all of our girls for taking that in and working their butts off this offseason. And we kind of smacked everyone in the face and said, hey, we can do it too. Just because we graduated some of the best players to ever play in the state of Iowa, we've got it too.
Well, that's the exact point, Abby, because a lot of people look at what Bishop Garrigan lost with great players like Molly Joyce and Audie Crooks and did not look at what you guys had coming back. So how did you as a senior kind of lead the way in this team establishing its own identity and its own sort of style of game?
You know, we knew that our style of game was going to change a lot, and like you said, we had to embrace that. We knew we were going to play a lot faster. We knew we had to be a lot tougher. We were going to have to help each other on defense a lot. We were all going to have to rebound. And I think we're still working on a lot of that stuff, but we've definitely gotten better and we're still growing and we're getting there.
Well, Abby, in tonight's game, you know, the adversity kind of hit the third quarter. North Iowa went on their run. They got it down to a six-point game, but you guys responded. I guess kind of take me through that punch North Iowa threw and how you felt you guys got the momentum back going into the fourth quarter.
You know, every team we play, they're playing their hardest against us, and that's going to happen. We just got to remain calm, and I thought we came out great in that fourth quarter and just went on a big run there.
Well, Abby, obviously one final postseason run for you coming up, and it's going to be a little bit odd because you've got a week plus here to kind of rest up and get back to practice and really work on things going into the postseason. I guess what's it like for you as a senior going into this final postseason run and knowing that you have one more shot at that?
You know what? We're giving her all we got. That's all you can do, you know? I'm going to leave each postseason game as tired as I can be. I'm going to run as hard as I can. I'm going to play defense as hard as I can. I'm going to rebound. I'm going to be aggressive everywhere I can be. We're going to leave no doubt. You know, each game, like Coach Swab said in the locker room after our game tonight, it's 0-0 now. Our record's 0-0, and we just got to come out every game ready to go.
Well, Abby, congratulations on the win and the conference title, and thank you for stopping by.
Thank you very much, Tyler.
That is Bishop Garrigan senior Abby Capacious here on Home Country Radio KLGZ as we're at halftime right now. And Bishop Garrigan leading North Iowa in the boys' game 40-27. Right now we're going to bring Coach Schwab in here and talk about the girls' basketball matchup. I guess, Coach, I'll start the same way I started with Abby. Obviously, conference title for the fifth year in a row. What does this mean to this group?
Well, to this group, it's a special one just because there's a lot of people that wrote this group off after who we graduated last year. And these kids went to the grindstone in the offseason and really worked hard. Went through a lot of adversity this year with, sickness and, not playing well at stretches. But, these kids are hard, tough-nosed kids that come to practice daily and come ready to work and, don't listen to the outsiders. You know, I mean, we worry about us. We worry about the kids in our locker room. We worry about us in practice and really proud of them on how they were able to capture a fifth title in a row.
Well, Coach, it felt like tonight you really got North Iowa's best shot, especially during that third quarter when they went on a run and got it down to 6 points. As you saw that North Iowa run unfolding, what did you feel were a couple of drivers of that?
Well, I didn't think defensively we were very intense throughout the night. For the outside of the fourth quarter, I really thought the fourth quarter we cranked up defensively a little bit and really did some nice things. But for the first three quarters, we weren't that sharp defensively. You know, I thought we had some good ball movement tonight. You know, we got a lot of good 3 points shooting from inside out, you know, whether it was high post out, whether it's a block touch out, and I really thought that that set up our shooters a lot better. You know, we worked that in practice against a zone quite a bit of, you know, we need to get some inside out threes, you know, when that happens. And I thought Abby and Graceland did a great job in the short corner and high post of finding our guards in rhythm.
Well, Coach, you talk about Eastman, and like you said, you played a lot in the high post, especially in the second half. What led to that adjustment?
Well, I just thought Abby on the baseline was a good passer and dribble penetrator from there that we could have got a little more kick out. I was seeing when the ball got to the short corner at halftime of how everybody was collapsing down. They had five players inside the paint, and it allowed that kick out opposite, because in the first half I was seeing a lot of open shooters when Abby got that touchdown there. When she dribble penetrated, I said, just keep your eyes up and look at that opposite kick out, and I thought she did a really good job of that.
Going into tonight's game, Coach, you talked about the need for better shot selection from your team. How would you evaluate that tonight?
A lot better shot selection. You know, I mean, we made, what, 11 or 12 threes tonight, and, you know, it came from not taking so many deep ones. You know, a lot of our threes were line shots. We took some deep ones, but it was after, you know, our girls had hit a couple in a row, and I had never have a problem with a deep one. You hit two threes in a row, and you feel that that's your rhythm. Absolutely, take that shot. And I thought those were the deep ones we did tonight. We didn't settle for that first pass deep three. You know, I thought we moved the ball a little better, working it through the high post, and we got a lot of good looks through there.
Well, Coach, I would imagine for you as a coaching staff, you guys are probably happy that it's going to be a week plus before your first playoff game, because it's a chance to get in the gym, really string some practices together after maybe having, you know, some sickness and games close together and that sort of thing interrupting practice time. So I guess, how do you plan to use this week before you go to the playoffs?
Well, we're going to take tomorrow off and give the kids a chance to go home, give our coaching staff a bit to, you know, work on and find what we need to sharpen up to go into the postseason run. So we're going to take tomorrow off and then get into practice and really worry about us. You know, we're not going to touch the team we're going to play until we see who we're going to play on Friday. So we've got two good practices that we're just going to worry about us. We're going to worry about what are some areas that we haven't been as sharp as, and really, really try to buckle down on those areas. And it'll be good to have everyone in practice. It'll be good to be able to work on a few of them things that, you know, we're struggling at.
Well, Coach, congratulations on another conference title, and we'll talk to you in the playoffs.
Appreciate it. Thank you.
That is Bishop Garrigan head coach Brandon Schwamp here on Home Country Radio KLGZ. As we'll step aside for a timeout, get back to the second half of boys action after this on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and at the Elgorda Radio YouTube channel.
We've got more sports club members making this broadcast possible on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Elgona Livestock, sales every Monday.
Countryside Barbecue Sauce, two sauces for all seasons.
Farm and Home Services, view their listings at farmhomeservices.com.
Holmes Animal Clinic, animals large and small, they love them all.
Style Salon, your salon in Elgona, create yourself.
Dance Connection and Tumbling by Michelle. Passionate about teaching, creative about dance. Visit their studio or danceconnectionbymichelle.com.
TAFE Wellness Center in Elgona and Armstrong. Keeping athletes in the game with chiropractic care. Take charge of your health.
Signworks for all of your signage needs, as well as printed shirts, caps, and jackets. Stop in or call 295-9544.
Down to Earth Tree Service, your local Elgona Tree Service.
Sports Club members bringing you this game.
Third quarter here on Home Country Radio KLGZ and the Elgona Radio YouTube live stream. Big congratulations to Abby Capacious, Coach Brandon Schwab, and the rest of the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bear girls team on winning a conference title outright tonight, as Coach Schwab and Capacious both talked about it at halftime here. But right now the boys team has a mission that they're on, and that is to finish the regular season with back-to-back wins, and they are winning 40-27 against North Iowa right now. Bishop Garrigan had an 18-17 scoring advantage after the first quarter, but a big 22-10 scoring advantage during the second quarter, really opening things up and getting a little breathing room here as we head to the second half. For the Golden Bears, we'll start the second half. Carter Schwab, Drew Mahler, Amari Thomas, Trayton Sink, and Michael Joyce. Again, I'm Tyler Lance. About Beanie Bodie tonight, Beanie has texted me and he says he's searching for the recently cited Amelia Earhart wreckage. So that's a big mission there by Beanie. So we wish him best of luck of that, as he's got some important things going on tonight. Meanwhile, back at this gym, North Iowa has the basketball to start the second half. The Bison They're going to come out with Bryce as well as Green Sky, Gerber back on the floor, Potter and Kramersmeyer, the original starting five for North Iowa. Gerber spent a lot of time on the bench during the second quarter picking up three personal fouls, and because of that, Bishop Garrigan was able to really go on a big run without Gerber in the ball game. So here we go. Potter passing it inside, intercepted by Thomas. Turnover forced by Bishop Garrigan, and Schwab brings it out across half court for the Golden Bears. Gets it left to Joyce on the wing. First possession for Bishop Garrigan. Ball goes right side to sink. In the post to Mahler against Kramersmeyer. He gets double teamed. Mahler looking for the kick out. Finds Schwab left wing. 3-point try off the back of the cup and a foul underneath. This will go against North Iowa as Amari Thomas is nodding his head, and Kramersmeyer is the guilty party for his third personal foul. Thomas having a good laugh down there, but Thomas is such a tenacious rebounder for Bishop Garrigan. He can often get the opposing team to commit fouls even when Thomas is going for the offensive board, and that is going to force Kramersmeyer, the center for North Iowa, out of the ball game. Carter Copen coming into the ball game as Kramersmeyer slaps the bench in disgust. It is Bishop Garrigan basketball right now. Fresh 35 on the shot clock. Joyce top of the key. Thought about pulling for three. He'll drive instead. He'll kick to Mahler in the right corner. Takes one dribble. Sets himself and swishes a three-pointer. Drew Mahler in rhythm. Knocks it down. 5 points by the Garrigan Jr. And a 43-27 scoring advantage by the Golden Bears. Mahler's a 35.5 three-point shooter this year. So from that right corner, he is a dangerous shooter. And now North Iowa has Green Sky flinging it over to the left towards Copen. Copen looking inside towards Price. Bounce pass towards Gerber. Gerber of 8 points tonight leading the Bison. It's Copen in the left corner. His three no good. And Thomas skies in for the rebound. Bears get it up ahead to Joyce. Joyce flying in. Joyce layup up and good. Price had his feet set. Joyce maneuvered the body just enough not to go into him and get a charge. And Joyce just absolutely flew in on that one to get his 12th point of the night. 45-27, Bishop Garrigan. First 5 points of the second half going to the Golden Bears. Price, right angle three-pointer, off the heel, no good, and Mahler tracks down the rebound. Once again, the Golden Bears forcing the Bison to go one and done on their possession. Joyce left corner gets it deep in the post to Thomas. Thomas against Gerber, powers it up and in! Gerber had to lay back a little bit. He knew Thomas could potentially get him for a fourth personal foul, so Thomas now has 8 points, but he got that great deep position in the post that time as Potter tiptoes the far sideline, checks his feet and makes sure he's in bounds as he gets it across to Green Sky, catch and shoot three, Green Sky, and he cans it. Green Sky, his second three-pointer of the night. He has 7 for the Bison, and it's 47-30 as the Bison will stop the 7-0 scoring run by Garrigan to begin the second half. Schwab on the left wing gets it up top to Sink. Sink takes one dribble right and finds Joyce. Into the post to Mahler right side. Mahler takes one dribble and kicks it back out to Schwab. Rotates to Joyce. Free from straight down the barrel. Rattles off the cup, no good. Mahler rebound. Put back, no good. Thomas, third opportunity. His putback's no good. Fourth opportunity. That one's up and in. Thomas now has 10 points. He stayed at the play for back-to-back rebounds. And it's 49-30, Bishop Garrigan. The Golden Bears are really hurting the Bison inside. Those three fouls on Jeffrey Gerber still looming large as Gerber knows he can't afford to pick up the fourth. And Kramersmeyer on the bench also looms large for the Bison as they'll throw it away. A turnover, and here comes Schwab. Schwab finds Sink under the bucket, makes the catch. Two defenders fly by. Sink layup good. Patient play there by Trayton Sink, and the assist by Carter Schwab, and North Iowa has to take a timeout. Bishop Garrigan has blown this game open to start the second half. 51-30 in favor of the Golden Bears with 5:09 left in the third quarter on Home Country KLGZ.
High school sports on Hometown and Home Country Radio are brought to you by these fine sports club members.
American Glass. For all your glass needs, think American.
Farm Bureau Financial Agents Dave Beisch, Jason Brace, Daniel Folk, and Michael Toll.
Kemco Tires. They're all you need to know about tires and service.
Weikert Realtors, the 515 Agency. A fresh approach to real estate.
Billy Offerman, your State Farm Insurance agent in Algona. Like a good neighbor, State Farm is there.
Iowa Lakes Community College, your community, your college.
Lusher Family Dentistry, serving your family since 1965 on Call Street in Algona.
BMC Advantage Insurance Services, insuring our neighbors for over 80 years.
Walker Chiropractic and Wellness, caring for Algona, Sway City, and the surrounding areas with chiropractic, nutritional, and physical therapy services.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
Big start to the third quarter by the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears, outscoring the North Iowa Bison 11-3 so far, as Bishop Garrigan leads it 51-30 here on Home Country at KLGZ Algona. Tyler Lance riding solo tonight. Beanie Bodie is busy listening to throwback Taylor Swift albums to get ready for the Super Bowl. You know what, folks? Even the casual football fan can enjoy the Super Bowl, and even the non-football but Taylor Swift fan can enjoy the Super Bowl as well, and Beanie Bodie falls into that category. He doesn't know anything about football, but he knows a lot about Taylor Swift, and he's listening to all of her albums tonight. For North Iowa, it's Green Sky handling the rock as he has 7 points so far in this game. Now it's Price right side, guarded by Schwab. Schwab, the leading scorer, 15 for Garrigan as Price enters the lane, tries to pass, and we've got a tie-up. That is a jump ball forced by Bishop Garrigan, and the possession is toward the Golden Bears. Right now it's Schwab of 15, Joyce of 12, Thomas of 10 for the Golden Bears, spreading that scoring around once again tonight. And really, the rebounding is the key. Second chance opportunity after second chance opportunity by this Garrigan team in North Iowa continues to go one and done on the offensive end. Schwab has the ball deflected off his hip. It goes into the backcourt, and that is going to be an over and back. The whistle blew. That might have been an inadvertent whistle. Potter would want it to pick up that ball and get out in transition and run and get to the bucket, but the whistle did blow. That is rightly Bison possession. But I think the Bison bench was upset there that they didn't let that play run. Price will inbound for North Iowa as he gets it into Green Sky. And we're rolling with 4.5 minutes left in the third quarter. Green Sky dribbles on the right wing. He sidesteps. Thomas shuts off the three-point look. Now up top it's Gerber. Gerber flings it over to Potter. Potter left wing triple. Left it way short. It's an air ball going out of bounds as Thomas lets it go. And North Iowa comes up empty again on their next offensive possession. Thomas will give off to Joyce, and we're rolling here at 4:13 left in quarter number three. Joyce had 12 points last time these two teams matched up. Already have 12 so far tonight. Sink gets it out to Thomas. Now Schwab on the left wing. Schwab had 18 in the last matchup. Joyce will try a three. That one's off the back of the cup. Rebound again by Thomas. Put back again, but that was an offensive foul by Thomas on the rebound. Thomas nearly had the put back that time, but he will pick up his first personal foul as he smiles and laughs heading back the other way. Even though it's a foul, you still like to see it by Amari Thomas. You got to get inside and be physical against a Bison team that just is not rebounding the same way Garrigan is rebounding right now. So even on a foul like that, you're still happy to see Thomas getting in there and crashing the glass and going after it for Bishop Garrigan. This is a lineup that's working. Garrigan has stuck this same lineup for about 4 minutes to start the second half, and why not? I mean, they've outscored the Bison 11-3 of these five on the floor, so Coach Meister and Coach Ferreira just letting it ride of these five. Price has the ball knocked away by Mahler. Mahler picks it up in the backcourt. Mahler sails to the bucket. Layup too strong. Sink falls, though. Sink put back, no good. Joyce put back. That's no good. Ball gets batted around. Ball rolls out to the far side, and Sink picks it up. Here's the fourth opportunity for Garrigan. Schwab shovels to Mahler. Catch and shoot three, and that one's off the heel, no good. The back tap by Joyce, and this is the fifth opportunity for Garrigan. Schwab, 15-footer, rattles it in. Carter Schwab from the mid-range knocks down the shot, and if you give Garrigan five opportunities, they will eventually capitalize. It's 53-30 in favor of the Golden Bears. The number one rebounding team in the conference at 36 per game. Well on their way to that tonight. Baseline floater by Price. It's an air ball, and it goes into the pocket of Thomas on the rebound. Out to Mahler quickly. Mahler down the center of the court. Picks the ball up. Goes left to Schwab. He's wide open. Three-pointer again. Good again! Carter Schwab of 20 points, and Garrigan raining down the threes. Nobody picked up Schwab in transition that time, and it's 56-30. Golden Bears slamming on the gas pedal here in the third quarter. Folks, this was a one-point game at the end of one, but the past two quarters, all Bishop Garrigan. 2:35 left in the third. Right side, Copen fading back, jumper no. Got his own miss back, put back up and in. North Iowa got a second chance point that time, and that'll break up briefly the scoring run by Bishop Garrigan. 56-32, Golden Bears with 2:22 left in the third quarter. Schwab gives left to Joyce, down inside to Mahler. Mahler takes one hard dribble, hook shot up and in. Mahler with the answer. He has 7 points, and the Golden Bears go right back on the offensive rampage up 58-32. Up top, it's Green Sky for the basketball for North Iowa. Bison have spread the scoring around so far tonight. Copeland of 8 off the bench. Gerber of 8 as well to lead the way, and Price has 7. Make that Green Sky 7. Right side three-point ball rims out for Hagen. As the Golden Bears get the rebound and force the Bison to be one and done. Schwab goes left corner to Mahler, heads right around the perimeter, stops on the wing and gets it out top to Joyce. 1:45 left in the third quarter. Left wing to Schwab, feeling it for three. It's good again! The heat is on here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. Carter Schwab of 23 points hits another three. 61-23, Golden Bears. They scored 65 on Friday night against West Hancock. Already 61 tonight against the Bison. One of the better offensive performances we've seen this season by Bishop Garrigan. And the Bison defensive struggles continue. They've allowed 60-plus now in 14 out of their 20 games, including tonight. Gerber driving in, hangs for the layup, got fouled and put it in. Chance for a three-point play by Jeffrey Gerber coming alive here at the end of the third quarter. But a lot of defensive issues for the Bison. They've allowed 70-plus in 7 out of their 19 games coming into tonight. So that's 37% of the Bison games so far this season. They've allowed at least 70 points, and it appears the Golden Bears are on their way to that mark, barring a major cool-off in the fourth quarter. Nemers and Bauer come in for Bishop Garrigan. Lear into the ballgame as well. Boy, that lineup of five players start the third quarter for Bishop Garrigan. Absolutely blew this game open as Schwab has a rebound wrestled away from him by Price. He goes out for a three-point look and left it short. Ball batted out, and it's tracked down by Copen for North Iowa. Gives it into the short corner. Gerber jumper too strong. Copen put back up and in. That time it's the Bison with four opportunities. 10 points off the bench by Copen and a 61-36 Garrigan advantage. Mahler gets it into Nemers. The knockaway by Gerber out of bounds as it will stay at Bishop Garrigan. But the lineup was Joyce, Thomas, Sink, Schwab, and Mahler for Bishop Garrigan. They played the first 6 minutes or so of the third quarter and absolutely took control of this game. Inbounds pass will get away from Lear, and now here come the Bison off the turnover. It's Copen. Runs behind Mahler. Mahler kept his back to the play, and he still committed the foul. Wow. Copen is going to head to the foul line for two shots. I mean, Copen was on the right side. Mahler was on the right side as well, and Mahler kept his back to Copen the whole time, just kind of feeling for him and checking over his shoulder. And that is going to be foul number three against Bishop Garrigan and foul number three against Drew Mahler. Free throw Copen up and in. Copen nearly 70% at the line this season, averaging 5 points per game off the bench for the Bison. And now their leading scorer of 11 points so far tonight. Second free throw Copen ripples right through the net as he has 12, and Bishop Garrigan still leading 61-38 in the dying moments of the third quarter. Mahler on the left wing. Guarded by Copen, dribbles towards the right. Copen reached in and fouled. That is foul number two against North Iowa, who picked up a lot of fouls in both the first and second quarter. Got Bishop Garrigan into the bonus pretty early in both quarters, but this time, that is just foul number two of this quarter against North Iowa. Mahler will take a seat on the bench for Garrigan. Bauer's in the ballgame right now as Schwab inbounds to Joyce in the backcourt as Joyce picks it up with 39 seconds left. 5 second difference in game clock and shot clock here in this third quarter. Bauer on the wing, looking inside to Nemers. Knock away by Gerber, and Gerber collects the basketball. Here's Gerber winging it up ahead. He'll find Hagen. Hagen gets it back outside to Price. Now it's Gerber, top of the key to the foul line. Gerber. Gerber kicks it into the left corner. Hagen catch and shoots, rattles in a three-pointer. Boy, did the Bison need that. The three-point balls have gone cold since that first quarter where they hit five threes, and that'll make it a 20-point game, 61-41. Bishop Garrigan in control here at the end of the third. 6 seconds left. Lear high post out to Joyce. Joyce at three. Joyce hangs. Top shot. Rolls into the cup. Poetry in motion by Michael Joyce on that one. Contorting his body at a crazy angle and hitting a shot at the end of the third quarter. 14 points by Joyce. 63-41. Bishop Garrigan heading to the fourth on 98.5 FM, AM 1600, and the Elgona Radio YouTube stream.
When you need cash on the go, there's no need to pay a surcharge fee with MoneyPass. Iowa State Bank is proud to be part of the MoneyPass network of surcharge-free ATMs found nationwide. Look for the green and blue MoneyPass symbol on over 32,000 ATMs across the nation. Or find an ATM near your vacation spot or travel destination at MoneyPass.com. MoneyPass, another way that Iowa State Bank helps people succeed. Member FDIC.
Bishop Garrigan trying to end the regular season strong. Right now leading North Iowa 63-41 on home country KLGZ. Bishop Garrigan outscored North Iowa 23-14 during the third quarter, which means between the second quarter and the third quarter, the Golden Bears have outscored North Iowa by a combined 45-24. Absolutely taking command of this game heading into the final 8 minutes. Carter Schwab has 23 points. Michael Joyce has 14. And Amari Thomas has 10 for Bishop Garrigan. On the floor right now, it's going to be Thomas, Lear, Bauer, Joyce, and Schwab for the Golden Bears. For the Bison, 12 points right now by Copen and 10 by Gerber. North Iowa has the rock to start off the fourth quarter. Gerber driving in, blocked by Thomas. A huge rejection, and now here comes Joyce. Joyce runs the floor, sidesteps Price, layup, spins out of the cup, no good. Rebound is collected by Lear. Lear's in the lane, and Lear got fouled. Oh, man, that was a highlight reel block by Thomas and nearly a highlight reel finish by Joyce, but the ball or the rim just rejected that basketball, spitting it back out. I don't know how that one didn't go down. That's about the only thing that's gone wrong, though, in the past two quarters for Bishop Garrigan, as Schwab inbounds from the left side baseline, gets it into Lear on the wing, back into the corner to Schwab. He'll try a three. He'll hit a three. Carter Schwab cannot miss tonight. He has 26 points, and Garrigan with a commanding 66-41 advantage over North Iowa. Schwab averaging about 12.7 points per game for Garrigan, so he's doubling that up tonight, getting inside and drawing the fouls. Hagen, or Copen, that is. Foul is going to go against Justin Bauer, his first personal and first on the Golden Bears of this fourth quarter. So two free throws coming by Copen, looking to extend on this 12-point night that he's currently enjoying. Earlier today, we found out about the postseason district basketball brackets. Bishop Garrigan's going to open up their playoffs 1 week from tonight. And guess what, folks? Conference rematch. They're going to be hosting West Hancock. Golden Bears, the number 2 seed in their district. West Hancock, the number 7 seed. Lake Mills gets the number 1 seed in that district. North Iowa plays in the, essentially, the play-in game this Friday night as they face West Bend Mallard. Winner of that game has to go to Lake Mills on Monday night. So North Iowa against West Bend Mallard will actually have the game for you on KLGA 92.7 and the Elgona Radio YouTube stream. At North Iowa versus West Bend Mallard game Friday night. Schwab, top of the key three-pointer. He finally missed one. Joyce gets the offensive board. Joyce, 15-foot jumper, and that's a splash. 16 points for Michael Joyce. 68-41, Bishop Garrigan, as the dominant rebounding effort continues. Bishop Garrigan's guards have rebounded really well tonight. Driving in is Gerber, and he's got to travel. Lear stayed vertical in front of him, kind of blocked the ball back into Gerber, and he ended up traveling and creating another turnover for the Bison. As Green Sky checks in and Price heads to the bench. 6:52 left in quarter number 4. But Schwab just lights up when he sees North Iowa. Had 18 points last time these teams matched up. 26 tonight for Bishop Garrigan. Schwab gets down to the baseline, right side. Picks up his dribble and finds Lear. Lear the paint now back outside to Schwab. Sets himself for free. Good again! What else can you say, folks? Carter Schwab is unconscious tonight. 29 points. 71-41, Bishop Garrigan. 6:25 left. Driving in, Hagen floater, left it short. Rebound by Thomas. Schwab brings it the other way. Schwab wants to drive this time. He's looking back outside towards Bauer. Bauer just left of center. Bauer driving in, sees a bunch of white jerseys, bounces at right wing right elbow to Thomas. Now Joyce beyond the perimeter. 6:04 left in the ball game. Pass into Thomas, gets away from him, and it's taken by Gerber. Gerber lost the ball, though. Schwab has it. Here he comes. Schwab scores again. 31 points. 73-41, Bishop Garrigan. 5:50 left. That time, easy pickings for Schwab. That was probably the easiest two that he's had of the night. Now it's Green Sky dribbling in between the circles as he heads left. Gets a screen by Copen with 5:38 left. Green Sky top of the key, rises for a three-point ball, and he hands it. Green Sky now in double digits of 10 of his own, and it's 73-44. Well, folks, I lost track of the exact amount of threes the Bison have, but that's got to be 9 or 10. And still just 44 points tonight. Not a whole lot of twos, not a whole lot of offensive rebounds and putbacks for the Bison, as Schwab has it right side. And not a whole lot of free throws either. Garrigan fouls a lot, but the Bison just haven't gotten to the line as Lear misses from point blank. But Thomas has the cleanup and the score. Thomas with 12 tonight. 75-44, Bishop Garrigan. But the Bison like to shoot from the perimeter, and that just doesn't lend itself to taking a lot of fouls. It's getting underneath and drawing the foul is Copen. Copen's really been the only Bison at the foul line of any sort of regularity tonight. A good high-low look on that last play, though, and Copen will draw the second personal foul against Justin Bauer, coming a 4:59 left. This is a nice game, though, for Garrigan to really get things rolling offensively as Copen bounces the free throw in. And, I mean, defensively for Garrigan, Bison may end up scoring above their season average, but they had such a hot three-point shooting first quarter that's really kind of distorting how well Bishop Garrigan's played in the second, third, and fourth quarters defensively. Golden Bears came off a lockdown game Friday night against West Hancock where they didn't allow a single Eagle to score in double figures, and they held West Hancock to 26% shooting and 3 of 20 on threes. So you're not imagining the opponent to be that cold every single night, and certainly the Bison were hotter tonight than West Hancock was Friday. Schwab, top of the key. Schwab drives. Schwab, Euro steps, dump off to Thomas. Thomas drops, picks it up, and Thomas got fouled. Kramersmeyer just came back in for North Iowa, is going to get called for his fourth foul. It has been a long, long night for Kramersmeyer, working against the likes of Nemers and Thomas and Lear for Bishop Garrigan. and it has been a foul-filled night for him in a night where he's had to sit a lot on the bench due to the foul trouble. Thomas foul shot off the back of the cup, no good. As we have 4:41 left, Price is checking in for North Iowa, and Copeland is heading to the bench with 13 points right now. Thomas will try the second free throw here as he's sitting on a nice night of 12 points for the Bears. And good rebounding that as well. Missed on the second one. Rebound is loose. Sink trying to peel it away, and he got it. But did he push? Yes, he did. That's going to be a foul on Trayton Sink. As the Golden Bears continue to scrap for every rebound. Again, that's one you don't mind too much if you're Garrigan. Trayton Sink picking up that foul. You just love to see your guys being as aggressive on the boards as they are tonight. Really establishing that team identity of dominating the rebounding battle. And it's good to see the three-point shooting tonight for Garrigan as well. They're not a huge three-point shooting team, but they're making them tonight. There's a right-side three as knocking it down is Jackson Potter. His second tray of the ball game, 75-48. Nothing but net for the North Iowa junior. Sink drives in. Sink no good as he missed everything. Rebound, though, by Mahler. They kick out to Schwab. The rotation to Joyce. Joyce across the foul line finds Thomas underneath. Thomas hooks the shot up, and he hooks it in. Right over the top of Kramersmeyer. Took one hard dribble trying to drive in against Kramersmeyer, then kind of faded back when he realized he wasn't going to gain any ground. Thomas, the big time scoring tonight, 14 points. Potter, free pointer from the same spot. That one rims out. Thomas box out, and there's a foul by Kramersmeyer, and he is done for the night. Fifth personal foul on Kramersmeyer. He's done with 0 points as Thomas had the inside position that time, and a frustrated Kramersmeyer slams his hand into the bench for North Iowa. 77-48, Bishop Garrigan. It has been that kind of night for North Iowa. The good news, though, is everyone, including the Bears and including the Bison, will start fresh once Friday rolls around. The Bison will play their first playoff game Friday. Garrigan will have to wait until Monday. Bison in that play-in game against Westman Mallard. Joyce, three-point ball, rattles on the rim and drops off. Ball gets deflected towards the baseline. Thomas saves it into Mahler. Mahler from the near side puts it up and in. 9 points by Mahler. The Bison and the Wolverines did play each other earlier in the season. And the Wolverines defeated the Bison as Joyce has the poke away towards the backcourt. It's a foot race of Green Sky. Joyce picks it up. Joyce driving in. Joyce got fouled and he put it in. Michael Joyce doing it himself on that one. 18 points by the Bishop Garrigan freshman. And the Golden Bears are above the 80-point mark. 81-48 with 3:24 left as Joyce heads to the foul line. But the reason North Iowa is heading to West Bend Mallard rather than West Bend Mallard coming to North Iowa is that very game early in the season as West Bend Mallard had the victory over the Bison. So the Bison will look to avenge that Friday night. Free throw rims out by Joyce, and the rebound is tracked down by Potter for North Iowa. 3:19 left. It's Green Sky prancing in. Green Sky layup good. 12 points by Green Sky. Nice job sidestepping his way to the rack, and it's 81-50 Golden Bears. Golden Bears can be a dangerous matchup in the playoff bracket. Like we said, they'll face West Hancock, try to win three games in one season against the Eagles. That's not going to be easy as Schwab tries from the right side. His three-point ball finds the bottom of the net. Can you believe it? Carter Schwab, he's hitting three-pointers all over the court, making it rain here in Buffalo Center, Iowa. 34 points by Carter Schwab, a career night, and 84-50 Golden Bears as the bench is going to be emptied here in just a second by Bishop Garrigan. Timeout is called on the floor. We are witnessing Carter Schwab dialing in right before the Golden Bears go into the playoffs. I mean, you're not going to score 34 points every night, but you will take it if you're the Golden Bears. The hot hand on the three-point shooting, the drives to the rack, the offensive rebounds for Bishop Garrigan. Schwab has brought the whole package into tonight's ballgame, and Bishop Garrigan with a 34-point lead against North Iowa. Right now on the floor, it's going to be Nick Lear, Logan Nemers, Tate Furch, Justin Bauer, Daniel Mice. North Iowa has gone to the bench as well. Noah Hansen in for the first time tonight. Kevin Hagan also on the floor as the Bison will have him in the ballgame. Carter Copen back onto the floor as well. The freshman Braden Gray seeing his first action. And Levi Brandt rounding out the five for North Iowa. There's a floater from the lane and the foul is drawn by Braden Gray. Fresh off the bench and immediately looking to score as the 5'5 freshman will head to the charity stripe for a couple of shots. Garrigan has Schwab with 34. He's done for the night. Joyce, their second leading scorer today, 18 points as he's finished as well. Free throw on the way. Will rattle into the cup as Gray able to knock it down for North Iowa. 84-51 Golden Bears. Free throw on the way again, and that one rattles off to the right. Lear grabs the rebound. Well, throughout the season, as we said, it hasn't always been consistent for the Golden Bears, and it hasn't always been pretty, but they do a lot of things that opposing teams won't like as Lear hooks the shot up, and he drops it in. A couple more points for Nick Lear, who now has five tonight for the Golden Bears. Teams do not want to go up against a team of three very good bigs like Garrigan has that can really rebound the ball like Bishop Garrigan, that has a physical guard with Carter Schwab, and also the great compliment of Michael Joyce. I mean, the Golden Bears, like we said, they're going to be 13-9 after tonight. They never won more than two games in a row at any point in the regular season, but they have a lot of things that are going to make teams think once the playoffs roll around as Lear gets inside and scores. Not to mention the deep bench. It's going to be matchup problems for a lot of different teams Garrigan sees. You just don't know what lineup the Golden Bears will use on a nightly basis to try to take advantage of the matchups that they're going to be presented with in the playoffs. So I think this Golden Bear team, something that Beanie talked about as well in our past broadcast, it's a team that is really built to win in the postseason. And we'll see if that plays out or not once district play rolls around. Lear is done for the night with 7 points. Garrigan leading 88-51. And Ben Gredeman, the senior, comes in off the bench for his final action of the regular season. Nemers is directing traffic. He's looking for Gredeman on the wing. 1:33 left as Garrigan leads 88-51. Mice flings it across to Gredeman. Extra pass in the corner to Furch. Top of the key towards Mice. Mice squares for a three-point try, and that one bounces off the rim and drops in. Daniel Mice from downtown. I'll tell you what, folks, that is no surprise. Daniel Mice was absolutely burying three-pointers in the JV game. He picks it up in the varsity game as well. A three by North Iowa was no good. Ball loose with 1:10 left, and the Bison dive on top of it. Nemers knocks it away, and that's a travel by the Bison. Noah Hansen was rolling around on the floor as the Bison will turn it over. But Daniel Mice had a Steph Curry-esque performance in the boys JV game, knocking down three-pointers in the second half. And he hits one here in the varsity game, his second varsity three of the season. Furch gets it left to Mice on the wing as he finds Gredeman left corner. 48 seconds left. Nemers in the post, right back out to Gredeman. Gredeman working the dribble, giving off to Mice on the wing with 42 seconds left. Nemers in the corner looking for Furch. Furch gets to the foul line, kicks it out to Gredeman. He's open. Let it fly, Ben. Oh, it's off the back of the cup. No good. Furch rebound. Kicks it out towards Nemers with 31 seconds left. Gives back to Gredeman at the elbow. Right side to Justin Bauer. Now deep in the post to Furch, and Furch scores inside. Furch getting the late bucket, and Garrigan leading 93-51. They won't quite get to the century mark tonight, but won't be too far off. Four full quarters of offense for Bishop Garrigan. Brandt the other way for the Bison. Brandt bakes it off the glass for 2 points. Levi Brandt gets the bucket. 93-53 is the final 7 seconds of the regular season takeaway, and Bishop Garrigan ends it with an exclamation point. A 40-point win on the road behind the hot shooting and 34-point night of Carter Schwab. There's the final buzzer of the regular season, and Bishop Garrigan gets lucky win number 13 heading into the postseason. The hope that 13 is their lucky number as they will face West Hancock in that postseason opening game on Monday night. With the loss, North Iowa falls to 2-18. They are 1-15 in conference play as they will finish in 9th place in the top of Iowa West. Bishop Garrigan 13-9 on the season, and they finish 9-7 in conference play. Well, both teams will now gear up for the playoffs as we'll take a timeout. Wrap it up after this on Home Country KLGZ.
Thank you to these sports club members bringing you this game on Hometown and Home Country Radio.
Kossuth Regional Health Center, make KRHC your home for health care.
Tom Eichen Sales, your store in the country, carrying steel and Toro products and Green Mountain pellet grills.
Algona Plumbing and Heating, where a good flush always beats a full house.
Runke Brothers Full Service. Experience the Runke Brothers difference for all your auto service and repair needs.
Erpelding Boyd & Company CPAs, they're not just about taxes.
Hy-Vee, use the Fuel Saver card. Fill your cart, fuel your car.
North Iowa Appliance Center, Highway 18 East in Algona, where they sell the best and service the rest.
Erpelding Excavating Enterprises, let them take care of your grading, excavating, and drainage needs.
AK's Chrome Kitchen. When you come in, your family.
All sponsors of this game broadcast.
The broadcast on Home Country Radio KLGZ is the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears tonight dominating against the North Iowa Bison, winning 93-53 in an offensive explosion. Looking at the final scoring by quarter for tonight, Bishop Garrigan had an 18-17 lead after one. This was a back-and-forth game in the first quarter that saw three lead changes, but after that, the Garrigan Golden Bears took over. Bishop Garrigan had a 22-10 scoring advantage in the second quarter, a 23-14 advantage in the third quarter, and a 30-12 advantage in the final quarter when the game was really out of hand by that point, but the Golden Bears just kept on shooting. Overall, Bishop Garrigan outscored North Iowa 75-36 in the final three quarters. That could be a final score in itself, but that was just the final three quarters of this ball game. The storyline in tonight's game, Carter Schwab, a career night. Schwab hit three-point ball after three-point ball. He finished with 34 points. Michael Joyce had 18 for the Golden Bears. You also had Amari Thomas scoring 14. Drew Muller had 9. Nick Lear had 7. Daniel Mice had 3. Tate Furch had 2. Justin Bauer had 1. I probably missed a point or two somewhere along the line, but Garrigan scored so much, it was hard to keep up tonight. But that was some of the scoring done tonight by Bishop Garrigan. For North Iowa, some of their scores in tonight's game. Carter Copen had 13 points. Brogan Greensky of 12. Jeffrey Gerber of 10. Brendan Price and Jackson Potter of 6. Kevin Hagan of 3. Levi Brandt of 2. And Braden Gray with 1 point. Again, some unofficial scoring numbers tonight for both the Bison and the Golden Bears. A good way to end the regular season for Bishop Garrigan. They really got the advantage on the glass in tonight's game. Ton of second-chance opportunities. The three-pointers absolutely fell tonight. There's really nothing you can complain about offensively for Bishop Garrigan. You know, defensively, you could say, yes, the Bison, they did get above the 50-point mark, and they did hit a lot of threes in tonight's game. But I do think the hot shooting first quarter by North Iowa kind of made the ultimate offensive output for the Bison look a little bit better than it was, because Garrigan really got in control of this ballgame once they got close to halftime and really ran away in the second half. So the most complete offensive night of the season by far for Bishop Garrigan, and a great way to head into the playoffs as they'll begin that coming up on Monday night against West Hancock. Well, one final update from across town, the Algona Bulldogs boys team, they defeat Pocahontas area 83-58 tonight behind 45 points by Ben Helmers. So that is what happened across town tonight. Both the Algona Bulldogs and the Bishop Garrigan Golden Bears pick up sweeps in their respective ball games as Bishop Garrigan's regular season is over. Algona will play at home tomorrow night against Cleary and Goldfield Downs, as we'll have that one on the airwaves for you on Home Country Radio as well. That'll wrap it up for tonight's broadcast. This has been a sports production of Home Country Radio KLGZ. I'm Tyler Lance signing off, as once again the final score, Bishop Garrigan 93 and North Iowa 53.